Josh Holloway. He's who so I probably good. Have to explain.
He's but. So good looking.
No, he's no boy next
who is
door.
It? Who is it?
Sawyer.
On Halas.
Oh, yeah, right. Sawyer.
That's no boy. That's office. That's bad boy looking.
Poor Sawyer. Back on the island.
He never got off.
The guy is doomed. The guy is never getting off an island.
He knows how to survive on an island. I
is he
him.
Is he squinting and scowling the entire time
hell
on your
yeah.
island? No smiling.
No.
Just me.
Makes it hot.
And I'm angry. All right. That's what makes him hot?
Mm-hmm.
I must be stunning. All right. Chainsaw.
Allie Larter.
Been on Dave's island before.
Yeah. Has he?
Yeah.
No.
What?
What? What?
Last time, I was listening to the tape of last time, you wanted her, and Chainsaw didn't know who she was.
I do now.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. There you go.
So.
You get her.
I get her.
Do you all know who Allie Larter is?
Yes.
Chainsaw was the only holdout.
Boyer?
I've probably seen a picture. She was in like a hot Maxim mag or something like that.
Who's Allie Larter? What color is her hair?
She's a brown-haired girl.
She's on Heroes, you douche.
Sorry, man.
Yeah, great.
Is she anything I would have seen?
Huh?
Is she in anything I would have seen?
Yeah, a picture.
Heroes. You picked Hayden on Heroes.
I knew she was from Heroes, but I don't watch the show.
Pick again.
Never picked up a magazine before.
Great. Thanks a lot. Super.
On the old tape, Blair knew who she was. That's funny.
I beg your pardon?
On the old tape,
when Dave was picking Allie Larter, Boyer knew who she was.
Okay, and you didn't.
Yeah. And I didn't. Right. Now I know who she was. I pick her, and suddenly Boyer has amnesia.
God.
You know what? How convenient.
You're looking her up. Why are you doing that? We said no looking up people. I got to take everyone's computer away. You can't do that.
He looked her up. I saw her behind his back.
I know. There's no looking people up.
Yep.
What about no looking people up did you not get?
The part apparently where you said no looking people up.
Oh, okay. Repick their chain. Allie Larter, quite the mystery piece in Desert Island 5.
Yeah, right.
Dang.
Well, I still think she's beautiful. And was she on any of the other lists that we listed today, Halle Berry?
I don't think so.
Oh, wow. How did we miss her?
Because we were annoyed by her for so long.
Yeah, we still are.
Oh, sure.
Deeply annoyed by her. Okay, that's fine by me. I will follow in Chainsaw's footsteps and pick an annoying Carrie Prejean.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, who is that, David? I don't know who that is. Ruth.
Adriana Lima.
Boyer? Adriana Lima.
Victoria's Secret?
That's right.
Yeah.
All right. What color is her hair, Boyer?
Couldn't tell you.
Then he doesn't know who she is.
God.
I knew you didn't know who she was.
I mean, I know I've seen her.
But you don't even know what color her hair is, so you don't have a mental image of her.
She's out.
She's out. You are just death in this bit.
I am. I'm sorry.
Between you and Shelly, death.
You know what? There ought to be like a 5 out of 6 rule or something.
No. Championship rules. Okay. Pick again, Ruth.
Okay, I'm going out on a limb here, but Nicole Scheherazade, she's the lead singer of the Pussycat Dolls.
Don't know her.
Don't know her.
Sorry.
Don't know the Pussycat Dolls.
No.
Chainsaw, how is it that you don't know the Pussycat Dolls?
You homo.
I thought you had all their record.
Don't call me that. And a poster over your bed.
Do not call me that.
That's the second time you've been called a homo.
And the last.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Or I'll bring it.
Okay, how about Selma Hayek? Or did I have her before, Emily?
Seems to me she's been on a list.
Seems like it.
Selma Hayek. But I thought like Boyer's list.
She wasn't on the most recent one.
No, she wasn't.
I get her?
I'm okay with it.
Boyer, do you know who Selma Hayek is?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, thank God.
All right, that completes round 3. Over to Chris Boyer, round 4.
Kim Kardashian.
Another annoying hottie.
Definitely.
What are you laughing for, Cookie?
I don't know.
Over to you, Shell.
Jonathan Rhys Meyers. Does anyone know him?
They're not going to know me.
Which one is he?
I know who he is. He's in that stupid, you know, King Edward the 98th.
No, Henry the 8th.
TV show, whatever. It's all the same thing.
I don't know.
What else has he been in?
Jake Gyllenhaal.
Shelley.
Jake Gyllenhaal.
Really?
What else can I do?
Yeah, I know what you mean. You know, you got to pick people that everyone knows.
Right.
Everyone good with Jake Gyllenhaal? Boyer?
Yeah.
What color's his hair?
I don't know. The tent scene was very dark.
Okay. That takes us to Emily.
This is a long shot, but Jason Taylor.
Help.
He is a football player, and he was also on Dancing with the Stars.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
We were fighting over him, Shell.
Yeah. Yummy. I remember.
That's the only reason I watched that year, because of that dude.
Sorry, don't know him.
Oh. Really?
What team has he played for?
That'll bring it for you, huh, Blair?
If I watched a Chargers game, and they were...
He played for the Dolphins.
But Dancing with the Stars is why people know his beautiful face.
And butt.
Gorgeous and tall.
Good-looking fella.
Yeah.
Stole my heart.
Can't get him.
All right, Gavin Ronsdell. Do you know him, Boyer?
Jesus.
I do.
He's not Jesus. That's a good pull.
Mm-hmm.
Chainsaw.
I'm going Walleye Angie Harmon.
Angie Harmon.
Help.
She's on the SUV show.
You don't know Angie Harmon. I mean, she's like, how old is she? 40?
Probably.
45? I mean, she's been around for quite some time.
That SVU show for 10 years.
I guess you don't get Angie Harmon.
God.
If you can't give me a, you know, that SVU show, what does that mean?
Special Victims Unit, David.
It's been on for like...
show.
That show's been on for like 25 years.
Okay, I'm not going to...
She is a 36-year-old walleye who's very pretty. But apparently I don't get her.
I'll cop to it. I've watched SVU.
You don't know who it is. Well, how do you not get these rules? She's if you like don't know who it is, you don't know who it is.
The star. But that's cool. Let's go with... age appropriate. Paula Marshall. She's the wife on Gary Unmarried. I find her very attractive.
Yeah, me too. All
right. She's hot.
I've watched it.
Do you know who she is?
I couldn't pick her out of a lineup.
Oh, Christ. God. Are you kidding me? You've watched the show. It's the co-star of the show
we have watched. We have to do this bet on day when Boyer isn't here.
Yes.
When he's got chicken pox or something.
Do it Wednesday at 8 a.m. next week.
How many times have you watched Gary Unmarried? 2-3 times probably?
Once or twice.
Uh-huh. She's the co-star.
The female lead.
Who's in probably half the scenes. She was the chick from NYU who caught Jerry and George and overhearing them talking about being gay and pretending they were gay.
No kidding. Okay, then I'll...
You
what
don't
color's
know
her hair?
She's a blonde.
Oh,
no, she's not.
See, you can't do this. You can't do this. He doesn't know who these people are. And you're using like a 15-year-old reference.
I know.
Don't turn your back to me.
Not to you, to him.
You can't use a 15-year-old reference on someone. She's cute, though. She really is.
I like her very much.
She must weigh about 80 pounds.
She's 45.
She's good looking.
Holy smokes.
Yeah.
Good actress, too.
I know. Boy, you're so frustrating.
I know.
I have like 10 names here, and they're all either taken or unrecognizable, and I'm down to Natalie Gulbis.
Who's Natalie Gulbis, Boyer?
I know.
Who is she?
I can tell you she's a golfer.
That is correct.
LPGA.
What color's her hair?
Just say the right one and we're in.
Blonde?
He's guessing, aren't you?
Yes.
You don't know who she is, do you?
I couldn't pick her out of a lineup.
Try again, Jay.
Anybody know Cheryl Cole from Girls Aloud?
Blonde, right? No, I guess not.
I mean, do I really have to get into the Jennifer Anistons just so everyone will know her, even though she's a pain, but she's gorgeous? Jennifer Aniston.
She's been on the list.
Don't know her.
She has been on the list?
Was she on the...
Not current. No.
Oh. Okay, just to move this along. Jennifer Aniston. Anybody familiar? What color's her hair, Boyer?
Kind of brown, blonde breathe. With the banana boobs.
I'm good.
Thank you for diminishing.
So is that your pick, Cook?
Yeah. Just trying to help.
Well, she is beautiful. Mm.
Great body.
My turn?
My turn. Boyer, get ready to just say you don't know who these people are.
Okay.
Joanna Krupa.
Help.
Okay. Jamie Presley.
Yes.
You know who Jamie Presley is?
Yeah. She's
all right, Shelly, you tell me you don't know her.
I know her.
You do?
Yes.
Jamie Presley, everybody?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Help.
The blonde from My Name is Earl?
You know what? I've got the wrong Jamie. Jamie King?
Oh, James King? Jamie King?
She changed it to Jamie.
Yeah, she did.
Yeah, Jamie King.
She was Gary Unmarried's first girlfriend for the first few episodes on that show.
And she was on Pearl Harbor
and
a couple other things.
Snaggletooth?
No. Maybe a little bit.
Beautiful girl.
Yeah. Blonde?
Yes.
Okay, I know her, Lynn.
Is that in or no?
Sounds like it.
In.
Sounds like it.
Does Emily know her?
Jamie King?
Emily.
Yes.
Okay, I'm in. All right. Chris Boyer, round five.
Wait, it's not me.
Oh, sorry, Ruth.
Scarlett Johansson.
Oh, she's been on.
Oh.
I know she's been on. I don't know what
she must have been.
Which
on
one?
Latest round, though.
Yeah,
I know. But we said if they've ever been on,
Heather Graham.
Ooh, good pull.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, nice.
How good did she look in The Hangover?
Great. Did you
that
see
girl
it yet?
Is just stays young looking no matter what. She hasn't aged great. A minute.
Yeah.
You know when my phone ding donged?
Mm-hmm.
Is a friend of mine here in the building. Who says, I have a great Melissa Miller story for you, not for air.
Oh.
Well, that helps.
So can we hurry up and break?
So we got one more.
Round five. Here All we
right.
go.
This is going to be, I'm out of girls.
All right. I'm going to take Avril Lavigne.
Don't know her.
You do too, you liar.
Whatever. It's about time for him to eat it.
I agree.
Is that it?
Yeah.
And Shelly, you saw Marissa Miller and don't know who she is. You saw the picture of her. You looked her up.
Yeah, I don't know who she is.
Okay. Shelly, your fifth pick.
Russell Crowe.
Oh, I like him.
Me too.
All right. Emilito.
LL Cool J.
Yummy. Do you know who that is, Boyer?
A black rapper.
Can you see him in your head? Again, this seems to be the problem not getting through to you. Could you pick him out of a lineup?
Probably not.
Cool J.
He's a well-built fella.
He's been around like for 25 years.
Lots of ink.
25 years at least.
Great big muscles. Yeah.
Mid-80s.
Freaking rapper. Beautiful.
Dimples.
Well, he was in kindergarten in the mid-80s.
Sounds like you don't get him.
What's he been in? A movie?
He's a rapper.
What
he's
movie?
He's been on TV. Probably nothing you've seen. Josh Jackson.
Who?
Who's he? Dawson's Creek, Fringe, which was the number two show this season.
I don't know him.
What was the name of the show?
Fringe.
Oh,
yeah, I've never seen it.
Just number two behind American Idol.
Yeah, I guess I'm an ass.
Chainsaw.
Could you pick him out of a lineup show?
No.
Of course.
I could. I bet you'd know him if you saw him.
Yeah, if I knew him, I'd know him.
Right.
No, you are right.
No, if you saw his face.
I would see the face. You're right.
You would know who he is.
Uh-huh.
You would recognize him. That's what I mean.
John Krasinski? From The Office, Jim.
Oh, really?
Which one's straws now? Jim, he's the main guy in The Office besides...
Quit trying to explain it. I don't know. I don't watch the show.
I don't like this.
Okay.
Don't watch the show.
Prince Harry.
All right. I like Prince Harry.
Mm-hmm.
I noticed you've switched from Prince Baldy to Prince Harry.
Harry got cuter.
Well, Harry got cuter. He got uglier.
Yeah.
He really did. I mean, he's turning into his dad fast.
Oh, it's so sad.
Yeah.
But Harry really came into his own.
Well, he's rugged. He's a helicopter pilot. I mean,
he's
come on.
More
come
like
on.
Mom. He's yeah. cute.
Everyone could pick him
for
out.
For Carrot Top. Boyer?
Yeah.
You could pick him out of a lineup?
Probably. He's the one with the big hair.
What color is his hair?
Yeah, what color is his hair?
Kind of a sandy brown.
No, it's red. It's flaming red.
You know that sandy brown. I've seen an angle with him. He and his brother were both going to be aircraft pilots, helicopter pilots.
Right.
One of them already is. One of them is coming into the services in aircraft.
Okay, can you see?
He has red hair, though.
I think it's so great you've memorized his resume. Do you know what he looks like? He has flaming red hair.
Come on. I would, yeah, I'd be able to probably pick
He's him. Colorblind. It doesn't count.
She might have a point. I have seen him.
Could you pick him out of a lineup?
Oh, my God.
Of midgets, yes.
Oh, come on. Stop. Can you pick him out of a lineup?
I could.
Is it yes or no?
Yes, I could.
Okay. It's fun with him, isn't it?
No.
Kind of. In a perverted way, it's very fun, actually.
All right. Chainsaw, your fifth and final pick.
Allie Larter. You familiar with what she looks like now, Boyer?
You're not allowed to look it up.
He did, though. She's not. She's kicked out.
Kate Hudson.
Nice.
Yeah.
Good one. Any objections, Boyer?
No.
Could you pick her out of a lineup?
Yes.
What color is her hair?
She's a blonde. She was in Almost Famous, and her mother is Goldie Hawn.
Very good. Wow. Okay. You want to tell me you don't know who Annalyn McCord is? Everybody doesn't know her.
Uh-uh.
No, I don't.
Okay.
And what was the problem with Eliza Dushku?
Was she already on?
People didn't know her.
Boyer didn't know her.
You don't know Eliza Dushku? You don't. Just say no.
I don't think so. No.
You don't know anybody.
I don't. I'm media ignorant. Yeah. I'm not the... I should have a pass.
Try to choose
on
a hot chick that would have been out in the desert last summer in an RV.
None of them.
I'm going to take...
You speak English.
I'm going to take Candy from 2 and a Half Men.
She was already... Well, okay.
What? You took her?
I swear I had April Bowlby on my list.
You did not.
I did. You didn't write it down.
No, you didn't, because I didn't know her at the time, but I do now.
Ah!
Sucker. So wait, I didn't write it down.
Wait, Emily did her homework here.
Well,
well, I'm writing it down right now on my list. Oh, by the way,
yeah, baby, give it some. I hope she gets fat and drags her teeth.
All right. And my that
turn?
Takes us to at 66 to wrap it up.
Christina Aguilera.
Why do I think she's been on the list? She's not been on the list? What are you laughing at?
I don't think so.
She was, but she wasn't. Remember I called you about that?
What was it?
You had taken her, but then she didn't make it on the next round because...
So she was on my list.
Yeah.
Yeah, she was on my list.
Oh, crap.
Yeah, Emily and I were talking about this last night.
Taylor Graham. Oh, I'm out of girls.
Mm.
Can I pick a boy?
No!
Dang
Jesus
it.
Christ, you people, I tell you.
Janet Reno's available.
It must be fun like playing like a complicated game like Monopoly with... Well, I bring my own rules.
How about Catherine McVie?
I'm okay with that.
Explain. Who is she?
American Idol.
American Idol?
Oh, yeah.
Winner.
Yeah.
No.
No, she wasn't. She made like the final five.
She's runner-up to Taylor Hicks.
Oh, that's right. Taylor Hicks won that year. She should have won.
That's right. Still. Boyer, who's Catherine McVie?
Catherine McVie is on.
Can you see her in your head? He doesn't know her.
Catherine McVie is it? Oh.
It's Christine.
Catherine McPhee?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you're right. It is McPhee.
Oh, McPhee. I'm sorry.
Yeah. But do you know who she is? Can you see her? What color's her hair?
Dave, if you could see inside my head right now, it looks like a fire drill at a mental asylum. I
just, will you, can you
I
make this
know.
Simple? You don't
tell.
Know her.
No, I don't
okay,
know
Okay, he doesn't know her.
Oh,
Fire drill in a mental asylum, David.
See, that's I can picture that. I got it in my head.
The frustrating thing is not that he doesn't know these people. It's that he takes so long to tell you that he doesn't know these people. Just come out and say it.
I don't want to stall the bit.
Well, you're stalling the bit.
Oh! I killed it!
Oh, you're priceless.
Ruth!
Man. Ruth!
How about Brooke Burke?
You know who Brooke Burke is.
Wild on E girl.
You know who she is.
Yeah.
Good pull, Ruthie.
Oh, she was on Bromo's list.
Oh, no.
Yep.
Oh.
Yep, she was on Bromo's list.
He's dead.
No, he's not.
No.
And we had Eva Mendez was on my alley before. Crap.
I know, it's slim pickings. You gotta, like, pick someone, like, obvious and dull and, like...
How about Kendra?
Okay, that's good by me.
Okay.
Yep. What color is her hair, Boyer?
Natural or...
Which hair?
The only hair we've ever seen.
What color is her hair?
I think she's kind of a brown...
Oh, my God! Jesus!
Her hair is the color of a piece of paper. It's platinum blonde.
Oh, then I don't know
where. Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
I can't believe it. That is just stunning.
Sorry, I pick her out of a...
You need to watch something besides
You're
PBS.
Unbelievable, man. You're unfucking believable.
I am.
It's you need to choose people who were on the Rockford Files. That's who he knows.
Jane Kennedy.
Don't just be sorry. Think for one fucking second.
I'll watch TV sometime.
Stephanie Powers.
Come on, Ruth. I'm going to get home today.
Naomi Campbell.
Who?
Naomi Campbell.
Ooh. I don't know who that is.
Supermodel.
Fits
black
of
girl.
Rage. Always Long sued by hair. Her personal assistants because she.
Naomi. I couldn't understand you were saying Naomi. I thought you were saying Naylon or something like
Naomi
that.
Naomi Campbell.
Okay. Yeah. I'm good with that.
Do you know who that is, Boyer?
Is that a black chick?
Yes.
Okay. What color's her hair?
At least narrows he knows. It down to about, you know.
At least he knows she's black.
A billion worldwide.
Hey, what about me?
Hey, yeah. Do you have a list?
I want to pick, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, I want Kate Gosling from Janet and Kate Plus 80.
Oh, yeah. Seen her.
Got it.
Know her.
Sarah Palin.
Got it. Oh, where was that?
Perez Hilton.
Wait, that's a boy.
O.J. Simpson.
Not really.
And Tom Cruise. Frozen in time from when he was on the Today Show lecturing about how meds are no good.
Oh good. Right list. We
That's
know
my list.
Good pull.
I don't know you.
I would have picked Sarah Palin. Where was I?
Where were you, Chainsaw?
All right, Chris Poirier, let's hear your list.
I have Chrissy Russo from Fox 5. I have Heidi Montag, Carrie Underwood, Kim Kardashian, and Avril Lavigne.
All right. Shelly Dunn.
I have Colin Farrell, Jake Gyllenhaal, Justin Timberlake, Matthew McConaughey, and Russell Crowe.
You like those dirty boys, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, the dirty B.O. boys.
Well, I don't have... Well, I guess I do have to smell them, but it's on an island. I don't care.
All right.
We're all smelling.
It's hotness factor.
Yeah.
Emily Toe.
I have Daniel Craig, Kevin Connolly, Josh Holloway, Gavin Rosdell, and Prince Harry.
wait a minute. I don't know if I know Prince Harry. Chainsaw.
The Carl's Jr. chick on the beach, Adrina Patridge, Danica Patrick, Halle Berry, Jennifer Aniston, Kate Hudson.
I always thought it was Partridge. I'm surprised by that. Okay, and I got Megan Fox, Susan Lennon, Carrie Prejean, Jamie King, and April Bowlby. Candy from 2.5 Men.
Nice.
And Ruth.
Rihanna. Frida Pinto, Salma Hayek, Heather Graham, and Naomi Campbell.
That's a good list.
That's a boy, international.
All right, there you go. There are the new Desert Island Fives. Now, Emily, are we going to put the web people together and list this stuff, pictures and the whole thing?
Absolutely.
Beautiful. Good lists. Good lists. You realize we'll never be able to do this bit again because we have exhausted the list of people that Boyer knows.
I know. Yeah.
It's Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw.
Stand back, everyone.
KTB.
Prepare to be amazed.
DSC in the morning.
I even watched that stupid marathon. That chick
too,
marathon.
Yeah. Who won that?
The chick who was far out in front.
A woman.
A damn foreigner.
And world-class rock all day.
101.5 KGB FM San Diego.
When Alice saw the new summer celebration menu at El Torito, she was excited.
Woohoo!
When Alice saw the new lower prices on all our famous sizzling fajitas and combos, she was even more excited.
Woohoo!
Woohoo!
But when Alice heard about El Torito's new lobster fajitas,
woohoo!
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 Come celebrate with new lower prices on all fajitas and combos, like sizzling chicken fajitas for $9.99 and combos from $8.99. El Torito, your summer celebration restaurant.
Woohoo!
Right now through July 31st at Breck BMW in the Escondido Auto Park, get friends and family prices on all new and certified pre-owned BMWs. That's every model, 3 Series, 5 Series, 6 and 7 Series, the X5s, everything at Breck. Now through July 31st, you can get the ultimate price and the ultimate value on the car of your dreams. Financing available through BMW Financial Services with rates of 1.9% on select 2009 models only through July 31st. Breck BMW in the Escondido Auto Park, your new sponsor for Race Wednesdays, Breck BMW.com.
Okay, who wants to be next?
Yes, my name is Jerry. I've been on the Weight Minders diet for 12 months, and I've lost 2 pounds.
Way to go, Jerry.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, my name is Bill, and I've been on the Goodwill diet for 1 week, and I've lost 374 pounds.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I made a donation to Goodwill, and I got rid of a lot of excess weight. I lost a toaster, a blender, 2 end tables, a couch, 5 sweaters, a pair of pants, 2 pairs.
We're not talking about that kind of weight loss, Bill. We're talking about dieting and making healthy choices.
Well, donating to Goodwill is a healthy choice, because Goodwill helps San Diegans get jobs, and that's healthy for everyone.
We're talking about losing weight.
Me too. I still have another 200 pounds to tell you about. I lost 3 belts, 5 pair of shoes, 6 board games, a little pony on a stick that sings a song.
Yeah, yeah. Who's next?
My name is Margie. I went to Goodwill last week and lost 150 pounds.
Way to go, Margie!
I'm losing control.
To find the Goodwill Weight Loss, Donation Center nearest you, call 888-446-6394, 888-446-6394, or visit sdgoodwill.org.
San Diego is talking about a new force in town, BMW South County, delivering the ultimate in time-saving, money-saving service. Plus, incredible discounts to move cars. Go to BMWSouthCounty.com before you buy your next BMW.
I'm about to present to you a straightforward commercial for GEICO, the third largest personal auto insurer in the country. Last year, over 3 million drivers switched to GEICO, and GEICO received a customer satisfaction rate of 97%. Standard & Poor's has consistently awarded GEICO a AAA rating for financial strength. This is usually where I'd say something cute or clever, but like I said at the beginning, we're keeping this straightforward. Goodbye to you now.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you hundreds on car insurance.
...101.5 KGB, Dave Shelley and Chainsaw Show, Cookie Randolph coming up with sports. We will talk action in the NBA, plus this day in history, future predictions, and sports, where are they now? Plus, Chainsaw with an update on San Diego Chargers' Curtis Brinkley. All that here, and a few more thoughts on our desert island on the 101.5 KGB Best of DSC.
All right, lots of reaction to our new Desert Island Fives. What a struggle. We'd have had that bit done in 2 minutes if it weren't for Boyer. Dear Dave, this is an email from Nick. Good pull on picking April Bowlby. Not only a very funny actress, but smoking hot to boot. I just saw the episode the other day where she's crawling around on the floor with her butt up in the air.
Yes.
When Alan's trying to discuss selling the condo, and all I could do is look at her and say, oh, damn. That's exactly why I picked her. That and a rat F. Boyer.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be any fun if there wasn't some rat effing going on.
A little bit.
Yeah, you didn't write it down.
I love that. Oh, really, Boyer? Really.
How's it taste?
Bitter. Bitter, David.
Well, at least you'll be straddling Chrissy Russo here in a couple of days, so
yeah.
You got that going for you.
For that, you have my thanks.
You're welcome.
When is that, Wednesday?
Wednesday, 8 o'clock on Channel 5, Chris Boyer has been invited to straddle a prone Chrissy Russo.
By Chrissy Russo.
That's right.
She wants it.
She wants it. Just can't wait.
On TV?
On TV.
Wow.
On her show. So it's going to happen. Hopefully she'll wear something special.
She always does.
All right. Here is Chainsaw with an update on sports now here on KGB and Q103. Good morning.
Well, good morning and thank you, David. And hello again, everybody. In the sports world, Chargers free agent running back Curtis Brinkley is in a Philadelphia hospital this morning after being shot in a neighboring suburb. You probably haven't heard of him, but his condition has not been released.
The local ABC television affiliate quotes relatives as saying the wounds were not life-threatening, but you know, that's not for sure, but that's still nice news.
Yep.
Police said Brinkley, 23, was stopped at his car at an intersection in suburban Philadelphia, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Just after midnight when a gunman walked up and started blasting with a handgun. Hey. Brinkley, who lives in Philadelphia, sped away to escape, and the gunman fled in a waiting car.
Hmm.
Sounds like maybe an ambush or random. Who knows? Police found Brinkley wounded in his car nearby. He was taken to Einstein Medical Center in Philadelphia.
Well, that's got to be the best hospital in the world.
You'd think. Brinkley was a former running back at Syracuse University, where he played four seasons. He was eligible for the 2009 NFL draft, but went undrafted. But this past April, Brinkley agreed to a free agent contract with the San Diego Chargers.
Well,
Curtis Brinkley.
Certainly hope this is not a career-ending injury for him.
Hopefully not.
Our Chargers are getting shot.
Mm-hmm.
What the hell?
And so was a notable former Tennessee Titan this week, as
I know.
We all know.
I know.
Giants pitcher Tim Lincecum no-hit the Padres through six innings before he and his Giants coasted to a 9-3 victory over the visiting San Diego Padres last night. The Cleveland Indians, the Washington Nationals, those are the only two big league ball clubs with worse records than the Padres, 35-50 right now. But with 77 games left in the regular season, 19 games out of first place is but a fraction of those 77. A sliver, a blip, do the math, a 58-game cushion. Do I have that right? Yeah. Anyway, Padres-Giants again tonight from San Francisco. First pitch, 7:15 on Channel 4. Sports Illustrated magazine has an occasional feature entitled Where Are They Now? Which reports on what athletes from decades ago are doing now. Well, this is kind of movie meets actors. The Hanson brothers were featured in a recent article. Remember the Hanson brothers?
Sure.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
From the Paul Newman hockey movie Slapshot. They played a trio of goons who come in the games mainly to fight opponents, right? The tough guys. One is now running a skating school. Another runs a sport facility. And the other is an electrician. It tells stories about these guys. In another profile, it's a little embarrassing. It also asks, where are they now about the 2009 Padres? And yeah.
Wow.
I know. It's pretty sad.
Wow.
But I can tell you where they are now. They're in San Francisco through the weekend. And then after the All-Star break, they'll be in, they'll host Colorado. They'll be here.
Mm.
Sports Illustrated is also planning out Where Are They Then issue, peering into the future. On this date in 2024, Jack Bauer, Brett Favre.
There we go. Almost. Halfway through a show. Halfway.
Then
on this day in the future, 2024, Brett Favre will consider retirement from football for a record 375,000th time, surpassing his own record. On this date in 2015, O.J. Simpson will still be in prison. And on this day in 2012, Sarah Palin will officially be president of the International Association of Moose Killing MILFs.
Nice.
So that's pretty sweet. Good for her.
She's on my island.
I know, and I'm jealous.
Tough.
In health news, 40% of Americans are delaying health care for financial reasons. As for Chris Boyer, he's just hoping those scaly green things on his junk will flake away on their own.
Ew.
I'm sorry, Chris. Did you tell me that in confidence? I'm sorry.
Thanks.
Great. Now Emily and Chainsaw know.
Well,
I was told they were effective.
Ew.
Can you confirm or deny that, Emily?
No.
They're not effective, boy.
The magic touch.
Scaly green things.
It's all about friction, David.
One ball Lance Armstrong steered around crashes yesterday in the fifth stage of the Tour de France, keeping him just a fraction of a second behind overall leader Fabian Cancellara. Meanwhile, in the National Bank...
It's the Onion Radio News. A Humane Society worker is secretly glad to see a nippy dachshund put down. This is Doyle Redland reporting. Marysville, Ohio Humane Society volunteer Catherine Moncrief admitted today that a small part of her was glad to see Oscar, a nippy, hyperactive dachshund, put to sleep.
Well, I didn't say this to anyone else at the time, but when they euthanized him, I was kind of like, ha,
Moncrief then privately mused out loud that for all she cares, the incessantly whimpering Cocker Spaniel in Cage 12 could go next. Doyle Redland for The Onion Radio News.
Okay. Skipball Association. Yikes. Laker fans are wondering if the combustible Ron Artest will destroy the team chemistry that helped win the NBA championship this year. Artest says he's been made to feel very welcome in Tinseltown. Actors and actresses have told him that they're glad he's arrived because apparently all the actors and actresses in Houston and Sacramento and Indianapolis and all the other teams he's destroyed haven't been so gracious.
The opportunity out here is just ridiculous. You know, I got out here and I met so many people, like a lot of actors, and everybody really is excited. And I was surprised, you know, because these are bigger stars than me, and they're telling me how happy they are for me to be here. So and I'm just as happy. I've been embraced, you know. I'm just sitting so excited.
Oh, wow. Good for you.
A thumbs up from Jack Nicholson has always been the key to a championship in other sports, David.
Well, you know Chris Boyer is going to straddle Chrissy Russo on Fox 5 next week on Wednesday. And yesterday we were a little concerned because she's sporting a great big flashy ring on the business finger. Guess what? It's moved to a different hand today.
Oh, costume jewelry.
Business finger is going commando today.
Yeah.
So she's messing around with you, my friend. She knows you're watching.
Every day.
That girl's a gamer. I'm telling you.
She is. Wow. The next Brangelina. The Boyer Russo. Beckham Spice Girl. This is going to be a media marriage. I love it. It's 8 o'clock and 34 seconds. This is your 101.5 KGB Sports Network. Oh, my.
It's the DSC. And no, the D doesn't stand for disco. KGB.
It's the summertime KGB.
Well, Mossy Nissan has been counting down all month long with big savings, but you know what? Time is running out, and that means there's just a few more days to save on all the countdown events that are happening at all six Mossy Nissan locations. Get this. Through July 31st, get to Mossy Nissan now for 0% APR for 60 months on all their great models. 0% APR on your good credit. It's happening now at all six Mossy Nissan locations. From Armadas to Versas to Altimas, get to any of the six Mossy Nissans.
So, to the gentleman in the pork pie hat. Now, ladies and gentlemen, up for bid is a ladies' weekend at a Santa Fe health spa. Who'll start the bid at $500? Give me $500. Thank you, lady, with a fabulous haircut. Now, $600. Say, lady, where'd you get a fine haircut like that?
Supercuts.
Supercuts, that's a smart move. Now, who'll give me $600? Supercuts, you say? How long they take? I say, how long that take to get cut?
Under 30 minutes.
Less than 30 minutes, that's a heck of a deal. Now, the spa weekend, looking for $600. And one more time, ma'am, you say you got that look at your neighborhood supercuts, looking hot, looking sexy. But I got one more question for you, sexy lady. Could they do as good a job on a fella as they did for you, lady, with a fine haircut?
They do lots of men's haircuts, yes.
Tons of men, but they take the time to make a lady like my lady in the front row look as fine as a Greek statue from the Hellenistic period. That's good to hear. Now, who'll give me $600 for a spa weekend? Even throw in a visit to Supercuts, I will. Let me see those hats.
For haircut experience you just can't shut up about, Supercuts, every time.
At Supercuts, you'll get a hot new look at an affordable price. Supercuts offers much more than just the hottest haircuts. Get color or highlights, a soothing tea tree experience, or check out their large selection of professional hair care products. Supercuts, every time.
It's backed by popular demand. Over 200 pre-owned vehicles in one giant location. A huge tent to house them. And this weekend, the giant used car tent sale on the mile of cars is being held at Perry Ford. Over 200 of the highest quality pre-owned vehicles in San Diego, all under the tent. All clearly marked down on the windshield. Many under 10 grand. Fresh trade-ins. Late model one owner lease return. Domestic and import. Even the hard-to-find makes and models. Toyota, Honda, Nissan, Chevy trucks, Mini Coopers, Mercedes. All under the tent. Many under 10 grand. Some under 5 grand. Plus, protect yourself with Perry Ford's exclusive 5-day money-back guarantee. If you don't love it, bring it back. Credit problems? We make financing easy. Great selection. All mix and model. And a 5-day money-back guarantee. That makes Perry Ford the right choice. Don't miss the giant used car tent sale. It's Friday through Sunday at Perry Ford. 2050 National City Boulevard on the mile of cars in National City. Don't miss it.
You must return within 5 days in the morning. 300 miles, rain damage. Not valid on compromising your vehicle.
At USAA Bank, we stand by some core beliefs. That the free in checking isn't just a suggestion, it's a mandatory. We believe an ATM machine should give money, not take it. And that fine print isn't fine with us. While banks are raking in $38 billion in fees from their customers, we're saving our customers up to $600. With us, you have no ATM fees nationwide. You also have free mobile banking and free USAA web bill pay. Because at a time like this, banks don't need bailouts. People do. Better banking begins now. Visit usaabanking.com and start saving up to $600 a year with a free checking account. usaabanking.com. Availability restrictions apply. Purchase of a bank product does not establish eligibility for or membership in USAA Property and Casualty Insurance Companies. USAA does not charge a fee for the first 10 ATM withdrawals and refunds up to $15 in other banks' ATM usage fees each month. USAA Federal Savings Bank. Member FDIC.
It's back. 4 days only. Giant used car tent sale at Qualcomm Stadium. Up to 2,000 vehicles from San Diego's best dealers must be sold. Trucks, vans, SUVs. Make us any offer. Trade-ins welcome, paid for or not. 4 days only. It's Thursday through Sunday. All vehicles are clearly marked and priced to go. Immediate financing available. Giant used car tent sale at Qualcomm Stadium. 4 days only. 2,000 vehicles. Parking and admission are free. Going on now through Sunday night.
Jean-Luc Tourneau, HD Radio Explorer. Day one. My digital radio adventure begins. With only a HD radio station map and a wheel of brie, my quest is to excite myself with new, undiscovered station. My journey will be long and full of the fruit. My cat croissant smells radio just over the horizon. Onward, croissant. Onward.
Discover free HD radio for yourself. Check out your local station guide online at hdradio.com. If you don't have an HD radio, you're not hearing HD radio. It's time to upgrade.
Right now through July 31st at Breck BMW in the Escondido Auto Park, get friends and family prices on all new and certified pre-owned BMWs. That's every model. 3 Series, 5 Series, 6 and 7 Series, the X5s, everything at Breck. Now through July 31st, you can get the ultimate price and the ultimate value on the car of your dreams. Financing available through BMW Financial Services with rates of 1.9% on select 2009 models only through July 31st. Breck BMW in the Escondido Auto Park, your new sponsor for Race Wednesdays, BreckBMW.com.
Hi, I'm Christina Lopez on the Saquon Entertainment Network. And this just in, Saquon Casino has the perfect summer formula. Hot cars and cold cash.
Now through August 12th, the road to Wintersville at Saquon Casino is paved with over $500,000 in cash prizes and hot new Corvettes. Club Saquon members get free daily entries and earn additional entries playing slots, table games, poker, and bingo. Your free Club Saquon card is your passport to travel the road to Wintersville. Every Monday and Wednesday at 2 p.m., 7 p.m., 8 p.m., and 9 p.m., you can win up to $15,000 instantly. Plus a chance to win a new Corvette every Wednesday night at 9:30. That's guaranteed. Cash winners every Monday and Wednesday, and a new Corvette winner every Wednesday night. Get out to Saquon Casino. You could be next.
The road to Wintersville leads to plenty of summer fun at Saquon Casino, San Diego's staycation getaway.
You must be 18 or older to enter the casino, restaurants, and theater. Please play responsibly.
That's the sound of finding a car just right for you. A truck or hybrid too. Where do I go? Show me the way.
Poway is ready to deal today through Sunday. Ask for them by name at the Giant Used Car Tent Sale. You'll get the best deal on any pre-owned vehicle. Take advantage of net cost pricing. 2009 Camry LE, $17,699 net cost while supplies last. 2009 Matrix, $15,588 net cost, and many more. Go to toyotaofpoway.com. It's not Toyota of Poway, it's Toyota of Poway. Go to toyotaofpoway.com and see the hundreds of cars available. And don't forget the Gen 3 Prius launch event today from 12 noon to 4 p.m. Free gifts, drinks, and food.
Come see. Yes, we'll put the right one in your driveway. Toyota of Poway.
It's back. 4 days only. Used car tent sale at Qualcomm Stadium.
Up to 2,000 vehicles from San Diego's best dealers
must be sold.
Trucks, vans,
SUVs. Make us any offer.
Trade-ins welcome, paid for or not. 4 days only.
It's Thursday through Sunday. All vehicles are clearly marked
and priced to go.
Immediate financing available.
Used car tent sale
at Qualcomm Stadium. 4 days only.
2,000 vehicles.
Parking and admission are free.
Going on now through Sunday night.
Hey, it's Boyer from Dave Kelly and Chainsaw. Evans Tire in Mission Valley is now open at 730 Camino del Rio North. All stores are celebrating the grand opening of Mission Valley with the buy three, get the fourth tire free. Join KGB at the official grand opening celebration Saturday, July 25th, 11 a.m. until 3. Enjoy free Papa John's pizza and drinks. Plus, I'll be giving away free Evans Tire oil change gift certificates every 15 minutes. You can also score free Def Leppard concert tickets and enter to win one of Evans Tire's grand prize giveaways, including four new wheels, four tires, four oil changes, and free alignment valued at $1,500, or a three-day, two-night hotel stay in your choice of 26 different cities. Check out the new Evans Tire, now open 730 Camino del Rio North. Same quality, same great prices on your favorite brands of tires. Don't miss the fun with me, Boyer from the DSC, plus a special appearance by the Pirelli Girls, July 25th, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Details, call 866-456-Evans Tire.
I'm about to present to you a straightforward commercial for GEICO, the third largest personal auto insurer in the country. Last year, over 3 million drivers switched to GEICO, and GEICO received a customer satisfaction rate of 97%. Standard & Poor's has consistently awarded GEICO a AAA rating for financial strength. This is usually where I'd say something cute or clever, but like I said at the beginning, we're keeping this straightforward. Goodbye to you now.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you hundreds on car insurance.
101.5 KGB, Dave Shelley and Chainsaw, the best of show, playing it back on a Saturday. All the good stuff from the week, including Naughty Girls coming up here on the DSC show. And it's a Shih Tzu party. Plus, we will take your calls. We'll discuss the Hogan Brothers, Desert Island, and who's in the Spank Bank. Plus, a gut shot for Boyer on the 101.5 KGB, best of DSC.
Hello?
Hi, who's this?
Oz?
I heard Oz.
I did too.
Your name is Oz?
No, Chris.
Stop it.
Yes, Chris, how are you?
Good, how you doing?
Cool, man. What's the reference for today's round of the commercial game?
Muffed.
Hold on for Emily. She's going to hook you up, okay?
Thank you, sir.
Right on, brother.
No muff too tough.
That's the slogan of the Hogan Brothers, isn't it?
Yep. Every time I say muffed, that phrase keeps coming in my head.
27 years, no muff, two times.
Name right. The Hogan Brothers, Route 66.
Oh, my gosh. Logan Hogan. I forget.
The Hogan Brothers would be so heartbroken.
It's been so long.
Jimmy Hogan.
Oh, yeah.
Logan Hogan. And Eddie Hogan.
Eddie.
My friend.
I remember that time they all got on the phone in the same call.
All the Hogan brothers did.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't there a Percy Hogan who was a florist?
Yes. And the logo was?
No Lily, too silly.
Yeah.
Rick has written me here. The email says, Dear Dave, I have a confession to make. As long as you're doing your Desert Island Five girls, I want the girl from the Progressive Insurance commercials. I don't know why, but I've got to have her. You know which one he's talking about?
Yeah, with the big red lipstick.
Does she?
Black hair.
She's got the black hair. It's like they're at the Progressive Insurance store.
Mm-hmm.
And she's just a touch stocky.
All right.
But Rick is all over her.
Huh.
Wow. She's a kooky, wacky
got
girl.
Got to have her. Her name is Flo.
Unconventionally good. Is she hot?
She's hot ugly.
Could be like a waitress at the Corvette Diner kind of looking girl.
Alright, Rick, you got her, buddy. She's all yours.
I thought he was going to say the insurance girl with the pink hair.
Well, she's a cartoon. So we're going with real people.
And cartoon people only have three fingers. And Handy just doesn't feel the same.
You've had one from a cartoon character, apparently.
Obviously, he's fantasized about it.
Well, you know.
Mr. Spacely, who gave you a Handy with three fingers?
You just imagine it, a pinky up. Jessica Rabbit with his pinky up.
I'll tell you what, that Cogswell guy's got more than just a good cog.
Okay. Well, thank you, Chainsaw, for that interesting... All right, email coming into the show here, dsc@101kgb.com. Dave, as long as we're talking about desert islands, what about that chick who's spilling out of her pink shirt on the Rosetta Stone commercials?
Oh, yeah.
I know what you're talking about, Kyle. Very distracting. They knew what they were doing on that spot. Hey, are we willing to go so far as to say that Boyer and Chrissy Russo are an item?
Yeah.
Well, we probably got to wait until I'm officially on top of her. And at that point...
You're going to.
She invited it.
Are we saying that they're an item? Even if it's only for our own publicity?
Yes.
Jane, do you agree with that? Jane, listen to our show. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, I would.
Okay. Emily?
Sure.
Ruth?
Because they haven't actually been anywhere together. Mm-hmm.
Well, I'll say yes. That makes it a majority rule.
There you go.
Okay, then I'd like to make a substitution on my island.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who's on my island, Emily?
You have Megan Fox, Susan Lennon, Carrie Prejean, Jamie King, and April Bobley.
I'll take off Carrie Prejean and put on Chrissy Russo.
I thought Boyer had her.
You can't have your own wife or girlfriend on the Desert Island Fives.
You're such a...
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, you're not.
What I am...
Mm-hmm. Yes, David, what is
what
that?
What I am is an American who plays by the rules.
That's right.
So, Boyer, who are you going to replace?
So, who would you like?
I'll take April Bowlby.
No, you can't have her. Clock. It's already taken.
He kicked off Carrie Prejean.
Yeah, you can have Carrie Prejean if you want.
He doesn't know who that is.
Listen, I wouldn't be able to sleep this weekend if I let that pass. That kind of egregious error in the scoring.
I love it.
So, who would you like to switch to?
Pick one.
I'm taking Leslie Ann Machado. She's the...
Don't know her.
Don't know her.
Rosetta Stone.
Don't know her.
Don't know her.
Don't know her.
I don't know her either. I like to know her.
Ruth, you would be all over her earrings.
Spilling out of the pink top. I've seen a commercial, but I only see guys on that commercial. Rosetta Stone.
She's the spokesperson.
Oh.
She's the pitch woman.
She's spilling out and I'll spill in.
I don't know her.
Let me get grosser.
All right. Give me Golden Shower Fergie.
Really?
That's my only... I mean, I'm down. I'm... That's scraping
now,
sound.
I got to ask you something. I know I've asked this already, but what was the issue that I couldn't have Eliza Dushku?
Boyer said he didn't know her.
You don't know who Eliza Dushku is. Now, if I reminded you that... She was the girl. I put a picture of her up on our website just like a couple days, maybe a week or two ago, of a dog with his nose firmly planted in her crotch.
Right. A little short.
Does that help you?
It does.
But you don't know who I'm talking about.
She was wearing a blue dress.
But you don't know who I'm talking about. You can't see her.
She was wearing a blue dress on our website picture.
He only saw it from the legs down.
You only look at fashion.
Well, you know what a fashion template he is.
That is a fact.
How do you not remember who any of these girls are?
Because they're not important to me.
Well, then what's your spank bank that you're always talking about?
Right.
What do? You go home and whack to a mental institution fire drill?
Pretty good, actually. The spank bank is usually a recollection of past actual conquests.
Emily is in your spank bank and you've never had her. And whoever said that? Whoever said Spank Bank is a recollection of actual past people?
No kidding.
No other guy
fantasy.
I know ever said that.
Not all of them.
What, do you got strict rules on your Spank Bank? You kidding me?
Not all of them, but the thing that helps the Spank Bank is that, wow, these things could actually happen. If they haven't happened already, there is a possibility that they could, and that makes them more believable.
You're just so weird.
And forwards the...
Now, who's saying this? Is it Boyer or Chainsaw?
I don't know. I get
them both, because I happen to agree with that policy.
That's nuts. You guys have never just... no chance ever in the world that you'd ever be with that person.
Of course.
Terry Garr. You never had her in the Spank Bank?
Ever.
Never had Terry Garr in the Spank Bank. I'm not a
even rolling
guy.
In the hay in the back of the hay wagon from Young Frankenstein?
As sexy as it was, it's never been in the Spank Bank.
Yeah.
It's got to be reality-based for me as well.
Really? You don't ever have, faceless people?
No.
No.
When you're tied up and upside down?
Mannequins that don't have any eyes or nose.
That's a fantasy of mine, a blank face, like a blank inside car. Just nothing.
Headless girls.
Yeah. You can't always see their face.
Jane Mansfield after the decapitation.
Yes, that's big in the Spank Bank.
Got the body, got the hair, but no face. Can't remember what they look like because they had no face.
No, unless they're turned away from me at the time.
I got a combination of that and fantasy, and then, top 10 best ones ever. that happened for
Victor?
Real.
Really?
You,
the snake?
You culled it down to 10?
Well, I don't know. I would just pick the number.
Boyer is taking Fergie, yes. Because Chrissy Russo had to evacuate.
Mm.
Oh.
And I want to thank Rick and Ramona for pointing out the rules.
Nice.
Thank you, Rick.
Rick and Ramona's going to be paying for his next fishing trip on the Daily Double, that's for sure.
Does Rick like to fish with you?
Rick enjoys a fishing trip, a free fishing trip every once in a while on the Daily Double. How's it going to feel writing that check, Rick?
Check this out. Dear Dave, this is from Charlie, who I believe is a girl because she spells it C-H-R-L-E-E.
Got to be a girl.
No dude would spell his name like that.
Yeah.
I had to tell you about a great vacation a group of 15 went on to Lake Havasu that included the Island 5. I was standing in line with my sister-in-law waiting to get coffee. I asked her who her Island 5 would be. We both threw out a couple of names but decided, think about it. Later that day, the Island 5 came up again with the rest of the group and it became a competition of who got who. Now, this was on Tuesday and we all decided that by Friday we would pick our Island 5. It was so fun all week coming up with people. Come Friday night, we all met for dinner at a nice restaurant and drew numbers for our Island 5 picks. We met back at our vacation pad and held the official Island 5 draft.
Oh, nice.
We had such fun, and it took most of the evening, not to mention all week, to get ready. At one point, we had to remind two of the guys who were arguing over a pick that they don't actually get the girls. Guys, get serious about this thing.
Sure.
Since that time, we've had an Island 5 barbecue whenever we get together and change out our picks. Thanks, Dave, for a great idea, Charlie.
Nice.
Yeah, it is fun. Glad you enjoyed it, Charlie. Let's see. Do I have anything else for you? Dear Dave, you should send Boyer to his Wednesday thing with Chrissy with a couple of socks in his junk drawer. If he packs it right, the viewing audience won't see it, but Chrissy will.
Yeah.
And the DCS fans, I think you meant DSC, being in the know will also know what is planned, so we'll see how Chrissy reacts to his tube sock. I think he should just wet his pants.
Yes, I do too.
I think he should have some sort of tube or vial in there that he could activate.
Yes!
You know, like a bag of money that's been stolen from a bank.
Yes, that explodes with the dime.
That 3 seconds after he straddles Chrissy, he activates that.
Got to wear your lighter colored.
Doesn't that would blow all his chances for everyone to see him again?
I don't know. She's kind of nutty. She might think it was funny.
She might
dig it. She liked his toilet joke.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
7 out of 10 girls thought it was funny. But I think there might be a director somewhere at Fox. That ain't going to happen, radio man.
He's from the South.
Apparently, yeah. Yes. They direct the show from Kentucky.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Wow. It's all outsourced.
You choose interesting dialects for your little puppets.
That is not going to happen, Mr. Radio
Man. All right.
What if the blossom occurred on the back of his pants and not the front?
Yes, come on.
Go with the potato in back.
Yes.
I think he should show up in a Speedo.
Yes!
Oh, sorry. That
nothing
was
but.
Right?
Just a Speedo.
With roses and a marriage proposal.
Yes. A ring. Chainsaw wants you to propose to her just so she can turn you down on live TV. I think that's a pretty funny idea.
That's all right. They'll think it's you, Chainsaw. Hey, Cookie, saw you on Fox 5 today, man.
Oh, you're hairier than I thought. Wow.
Wow, I'm looking like at you now, and you don't look anything like the person on television.
What if Chrissy Russo is secretly in love with Chainsaw and doesn't know it? What if she thinks Chainsaw is coming out to straddle her, and then all of a sudden this polar bear shows up?
What an embarrassing mistake.
What are you doing here? I want the tall sports guy. You know, Boyer.
I'm the spruce guy.
That goes back to the back of the pants. Come on.
No, baby, that's in front.
Great story.
Yeah.
Compelling and rich.
Tiger Woods, you have any thoughts on that?
It comes in spurts.
Yeah, what if you wore one of those Borat-style banana hammocks, you know?
Yes.
Over the shoulder right down to a barely there mankini. How hilarious would that be?
I love it.
We'll talk about something.
We'll talk?
Probably not.
I think that means yes. Aw.
KGB, this is
the best of the DSC.
Rocking your summer.
Hello, summer.
Beach bunnies, beware.
This is KGB.
Hey,
here we go. Time for Naughty Girls. Just as promised. 888-570-1015. Haven't all girls been naughty at one time in their life?
That's probably true.
I mean, if you had to classify, if you had to clarify for us, what was the naughtiest thing you've ever done?
Well, yeah, I was in college for 5 years. I was on the 5-year plan.
Congratulations. Did you get a diploma after that?
No.
That's not a 5-year plan. That's called flunking out.
It would have been a 6-year plan, but I just decided to wrap it up.
I went to a 2-year college years.
You must have been close.
I'm a semester away of upper division electives, yeah.
You must think about going back and getting it from time to time. Not really.
Not really.
What was your major?
Journalism. Or radio, TV, film, I think is what it was called.
Blow yeah. off.
I know.
Who can't finish a radio course in 5 years?
I know.
And Ruth, you went to a 2-year college for 6 years?
Yep.
What the hell?
And did not get a degree.
Is that possible?
Because I had a job first, so I took that.
Yeah, once I got the job, I thought, who cares about the paper?
And I kept flunking biology. Like on the first week, the first quiz, I got a D. Second quiz, I got a D. No, so I quit. I dropped out, so I didn't get D's. Because at the beginning, the first week is a D. So I would have graduated if I would have taken a life science with a lab.
You would have graduated had you graduated.
Right.
6 years in a 2-year institution and nothing to show for it. No paper.
But I got a job. That's what I get to show for.
Turns out you're just stupid. All right. Naughtiest thing you've ever done. If it turns out you are the naughtiest girl of them all, you're taking my very last pair of tickets to Coldplay. And you know what? I'll throw in something nice for you. How's that sound? How about a nice 80-minute spa service and lunch at the Spa Cafe La Costa Resort and Spa?
Yes.
Girls love that stuff.
Oh, yes.
How about that? And you know what? I'll give you one for your friend so you don't have to go alone.
Nice.
I'll give you two.
The nicest spa.
80-minute spa services and lunch. Spa Cafe from La Costa Resort and Spa. So that's what you get if you're the naughtiest girl of them all.
Nice.
And I know you're first in line here, Cindy, so let's hear it.
Okay. Way in back in the days, I used to make bets for a customer of mine because he was on probation and couldn't go to Vegas. So he used to pay for me to go to Vegas. Make these bets.
Who's getting turned on just by the voice? Come on, seriously.
I want to smoke a cigarette.
And took him for a week.
Sounds like Uncle Joe was talking to me.
And then to top it off, on the way home, we were on the plane, and you know, I said, well, you know, let's be a member of the Mile High Club, and he didn't want to. He was too chicken. I said, oh, okay, well, just sit back and take a nap, and I'll take a nap in your lap. And we did a little waha waha all the way from Vegas all the way to L.A. And the words he'll never forget is, fasten your seatbelts, we're landing.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
And the best thing of all, we're been married 20 years now.
Oh, congratulations. Yeah. All right, thanks for starting us off there, Cindy.
All righty.
I think you might have been a little too vigorous. It worked on one of the vocal cords there.
He's just well endowed.
All right, Christy's going to be next here on Naughty Girls. Christy, you a naughty girl?
I'm a naughty girl.
All right, good. Glad to hear it. Let's hear what you did.
Well, I was helping a captain bring a boat back from Mexico, and one of the guys that was on the boat didn't even speak any English, and I had night watch at the wheelhouse. We were driving the boat back to San Diego, and we did it in the wheelhouse.
And he didn't even speak English?
No English.
So how did you, what happened?
I didn't speak Spanish either.
Yeah, well, and you'd never met this guy before?
Well, we cleaned the boat together a couple times.
I see. So you two had been, like, you know, sizing each other up.
Oh, yeah. Well, he flirted with me in his Mexican little way, you
mm-hmm,
know?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
With the language of love.
Latino lover.
I like to dip my chip in his salsa. Yeah. So right there in the wheelhouse.
Yeah, right there in the captain's wheelhouse. He was probably about 2 bunks away, the captain sleeping.
Wow.
Mm.
What's his name?
We had about 3 hours all on our own.
Yeah, what was his name?
Which captain? You want to know the captain's name?
No, no, the guy you did in the wheelhouse.
Oh, we'll just call him Jose.
Okay. And then I did Hose B.
Yes.
Thank you. That's all the naughty girls I got, Emily?
What? I know.
Well, then tell me a naughty story about you, Emily. Go ahead.
Good job.
Go ahead.
I'm an innocent, sweet little girl.
Who bruises her soft palate.
And then she bursts into flames.
Has there been any action there since the bruised soft palate?
Yeah.
Well, give it up. Let's hear.
But it wasn't super naughty.
Where was it? What was it? We'll decide.
Don't you want to go see Coldplay and go to the spa? What happened?
I went. There was the Hawaii guy. He wasn't the soft palate.
Oh, okay.
Oh, there. Look, hang on.
Saved
by the bell. Hi, you're on the DSC.
I have a naughty story.
Good. I want to hear. What's your name?
I'm not going to say my name.
Just make one up for me so I can talk to you.
What's up?
What did you say?
Make up a name.
Yeah, make up a name so I can talk to you.
Sarah.
Okay, Sarah. Tell me your naughty girl story.
I was with my boyfriend and we were at his parents' house. They were asleep in the next room and we were on the kitchen table.
Oh, wow. Kitchen table. Mm. Dad gets up for a glass of water. You're going to get busted.
Pretty much.
Is that scary for you?
Considering his parents were in the next room. Yeah.
All right, hold on, Sarah. We got to get your telephone number here. Hi, you're on Naughty Girls.
Dev.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, good. I'd like to send you out to the La Costa Resort and Spa.
Yeah, I just want to go. I'm like, those stories are lame. I just want to go.
Okay, well, tell me your story.
I don't even have a story. I just want to go.
Brother.
Make one up.
You know what? Come on. Every girl's got a story. What's the naughtiest? First of all, tell me your name.
Addie.
Okay. Now what?
Oh no, that's girl I work with. She's like, oh my god, don't say my name.
See, that's what women do. They look around and say, all right, whose name am I going to use here?
Exactly.
Yeah, well, that's all right. Did you say Abby or Addie?
No, I can't say it's Addie, but no.
Okay, Addie, tell me the naughtiest thing you've ever done.
Oh my gosh!
Come on, I won't tell anybody. It's just you and me.
I know. Oh, she went on a cruise, and she did her boyfriend, and then she did another guy, and then went back to her boyfriend.
Oh.
I know.
Shopped around a little bit with the customers there on the high seas, huh? Addie, you whore.
I know. We didn't want to go to Coldplay. We're like, oh, my God, we don't even have a story.
I don't blame you. You hold on, okay, Addie the whore?
Okay.
Addie the high seas whore.
Oh, that's just disgusting.
I've known some radio guys who've done that.
Mm-hmm.
What? Wait a minute. Hi, you're on Naughty Girls.
Hi.
Hi, who's this?
Well, I'm going to make up a name.
I don't care. Doesn't matter.
My name's Kim.
Okay, Kim, tell me your naughty girl story.
Well, it all started out on vacation because my parents, they're really naughty, and everywhere we went, they were getting it on. So then my husband and I decided we needed to try to keep up. So we did it in the elevator at Mount Rushmore on a crowded afternoon. And it was actually the day before 4th of July. So it was really crowded.
How do you do it on an elevator? I don't understand. I mean, believe me, I'm no marathon man. But, you know, how do you do it on an elevator without it opening and letting people in by the time you're done getting to your floor? I mean, it seems too quick.
It's really quick. And we didn't finish. And when the door opened, my mother-in-law was standing there.
Oh, my.
So did he do her then? She heard there was some elevator action going on. She wanted a dip. Yeah. All right, that's very good, Kim. Hold on. I've got to get your telephone number. You know what I mean? I mean, how long does it take to get from the bottom floor to, you know, even if you're in a big building, it's not going to take more than 30 seconds, is it?
Well, especially if the guy on the next floor punches the button to call it.
Right.
And if you turn off an elevator, doesn't it always ring a bell?
That's what I found.
That's what I thought. All right, Tanya, you're next here on Naughty Girls.
Hey, Dave, how you doing?
Good. Now that you're on the show, let's hear your naughty girl story.
Okay, I was dating this guy, and we were happened to be staying in a hotel room for about a few weeks, and I had sex in front of a room full of people, like, a few times.
And did they know what was going on?
I'm pretty sure. I'm not real quiet.
And how many people?
I don't know, 10 or 12.
That's a crowded hotel room.
Yes, it is.
It is.
Why are there so many people? Why so many people in the room?
He was a drug dealer, so people tend to hang out.
worthless. For some throwdowns, you know?
Yeah. All right, that's good, Tanya.
All right.
We got a number on Tanya?
No.
Hold on, Tanya. All right, Kim. Your turn.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you guys?
Great. Let's hear your naughty girl story.
I went with my boyfriend to go see Horton Hears a Who the day it opened, and we kind of got a little freaky in the theater. Yeah. And it was, like, packed.
Wow.
What was packed? You or the theater?
I don't know. I think the both of us were packed.
Lots of kids went to see that movie.
I know, but we were quiet, and at least the back row was empty.
Wow. All right. Hold on.
Horton Hears a...
That would be so much funnier if I didn't have to see your face when you did that.
Look away.
Poor Chrissy. Oh, she has no idea what she's in for. All right, Kendra, you're next here. It's naughty girl time for you.
Hi. Okay, so my boyfriend at the time and I were staying over at my friend's grandma's house, and in the morning we were sitting on a little flower couch under the blanket and getting a little frisky, and then she came out of the room, so I popped into his lap and we were actually doing the dirty while she talked to us for about 5-6 minutes. She kind of seen out, but we just sat there and had sex on the lap while she was in there watching us and talking to us. She had no idea.
Did she know that he was even there?
I don't know, maybe.
Wow. Maybe. That's funny.
Yeah.
All right, that's a good one. All right, thank you, Kendra.
Thanks.
Charlene, you're on Naughty Girls.
Hi. My story is kind of a little different. When my husband and I were on our honeymoon, we didn't have enough money to have a honeymoon, so we went up to our in-laws, well, my now-in-laws, lake house, and we were... going at it. We were having sex, and we decided that the front porch would be good, and we thought there were no neighbors around. And we were having sex on the front porch in the porch swing, and broke the porch swing, and later found out that the neighbor was home, and he was watching us, and he was, like, in his 70s. And this morning, when we went to the, or the, all the family came over to have lunch and dinner, and and do our boating thing, my mother-in-law sat on the swing and the swing broke, and we blamed it on her.
What'd you do?
I love that.
You always got to blame it on someone else.
Love that.
She probably knows now. Nobody knows till now.
Right. All right, very good. Thank you, Charlene. Are you calling for naughty girls?
Yes, I am.
All right, what's your name?
Karina.
Okay, Karina. Tell me
your
naughty...
Oh, my God, I said my name. That just makes it sound worse.
Uh-huh.
That's all right. There's more than one Karina in the world. Tell me your naughty girl story.
Let's see. One afternoon after partying, about six of me and my friends, including my cousin and my best friend, decided to go out into the jacuzzi for a while. And it turns out I was with my boyfriend, and I don't know how nobody noticed, but I kept sitting on his lap for a while. And everybody says it's just it's because there was lots of bubbles around, but we ended up having sex while everybody was in the jacuzzi.
And you don't think they knew?
I don't know. Nobody knew. And I had to explain it to my best friend the very next day, and she said that was kind of gross. Little by little, they all started exiting the jacuzzi.
Uh-huh. Yeah, well, they all didn't want to be in your soup.
Yeah, no kidding.
Well, you know, you got to do what you got to do. Luckily, we're on our way right now to a bachelorette party in Las Vegas, so hopefully I'll be able to have another naughty girl story to call back later.
I would love that. I would love that. I mean, how can you not have a naughty girl story if you're going to a bachelorette party in Vegas? I mean, are you playing Katy Perry right now? Is Katy Perry on the radio right now?
Well, I can't turn up the radio right now because, you know, it messes up that whole thing on the radio.
Yeah, I know what you mean. But so what's the plan for Las Vegas? What are you guys
going
to do?
There's 8 of us going, and we're just trying to pretend that nobody has a boyfriend this weekend.
Uh-huh.
And we're supposed to go see some naked men on Saturday. And
you're going to go see the Thunder Down Under?
No, actually, we're going to Olympic Gardens.
Okay, all right. There's another place called, like, the Spearmint Rhino or something like that. There's plenty of places to go and watch naked men.
There's tons of them.
Yeah. All right. Well, I expect to hear from you on your. I expect you to be too hungover to call me on Monday, so you call me on Tuesday and tell me your story. Okay.
I will do that. Definitely.
All right. All right. You hold on. I got to get your phone number in case you win. Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Have fun in Vegas. We're going to break for a second here. KGB and Q103. Naughty Girls continues. Chance for you to get on the radio with us. If you're the naughtiest girl of them all, I got tickets for you to go to Coldplay and the spa, La Costa. You're on the radio with us next. The KGB and Q103.
Shelly and Chainsaw.
This will make you feel good.
Are a registered trademark of KGB.
KGB! World-class summertime rock. This is KGB.
All right. Let's wrap up Naughty Girls, shall we? We'll listen to the stories. We'll all vote which one was the naughtiest of them all. And you're taking my Coldplay tickets. And you're off to the La Costa Resort and spa. You and a friend get to go.
Oh.
I don't want you to have to go alone. Take your girlfriend with you.
Nice.
Have lunch on me. Carrie, you're on Naughty Girls.
Hi.
Hi.
My story is I was partying downtown, down in PB with my husband and his cousin and some other girl. And we had enough of the bar scene, so we decided to go down to the beach. And I dropped my clothes on the shore. They all followed me. And we went into the water. I covered my husband in seaweed and took him under the pier and sucked his sea cucumber with people on the beach.
Sea cucumber. All right, Carrie, you're a good girl. You keep that up, all right?
I will do that.
All right. We'll put you in the running. Tina, you're on Naughty Girls. What's going on?
Hi, how's everybody?
Very good, thank you. Glad to hear you here. Let's hear your story.
So I sit in traffic every single day on the 5 to and from work, just sitting there. So it started last summer when it was just a hot summer day and I'm heading home. And I wore a skirt to the office. So I'm sitting there just driving along in traffic. And you always have like the big truck drivers. They're always cocking their head. And you're just like, they're totally going to hit that person in front of them. Because it's all the time. And I just started slowly pulling my skirt up as I went in traffic farther and farther.
Mm-hmm.
So then they're like practically like stopping. And I was like, I'm kind of enjoying this. So I ended up just kind of teasing all the truck drivers and everything just as I drove in traffic. And it just kind of became a regular thing because I would come home to my husband completely turned on from turning on all the other drivers.
Look at you. You are a naughty girl.
Yeah, a little naughty.
All right.
Innocent fun.
That's right. Good job, Tina. Angie?
Yes. Hello, Dave. How are you?
I'm interested in your story. You seem to be a naughty girl, Angie.
I'm just going to tell one of the milder ones because I do have family that listens.
holding back on me, huh?
Yeah. Well, I moved up to Temecula. My ex-husband had moved up there, so I wanted to keep my son near him. So I moved in with him for about 6 months, and my downstairs neighbor introduced me to my now husband. Well, he came over one night, and it was a hot summer's night. We were enjoying some ice cream, so leaned him up against the counter and gave him a waha waha with some mint chocolate chip ice cream. And about halfway through, I look over and my
single neighbor staring through his kitchen window watching us, and we just gave him a thumbs up, and he's a lonely old man. Why not let him watch?
I gave him a thumbs up.
I know.
All right, Angie.
That's right, Dave. You guys have a good day.
Do you realize you're a naughty girl?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, I do.
Okay. Well, keep it up, all right?
I will.
All right. Good girl. Linda.
Hi, Dave. How are you?
I'm all right. How are you naughty?
Let's hear it, Linda.
I've been naughty a long time. When I was younger, I used to clean houses all the time. And
Bragger.
My husband stopped by to see how it was going and ended up chasing me through the house. And it was pretty funny. We were having a good time. There were clothes everywhere and ended up in the bedroom and had to change the sheets anyway. Might as well make it good. So,
yeah.
Yeah, because you want to do it on somebody's dirty bed sheets.
Who cares? We were having a good time.
Now you know.
All of a sudden, my husband screams and jumps up and takes the blankets with him. I go, what the hell? I'm not that good yet. We're still working on it. And he goes, my mom was here. I'm going, what the hell? Whoops, sorry. She had come to bring me lunch and walked in. I thought I'd die.
I'm lost.
I am too.
I completely lost the story. I feel like I've been reading a social studies book. She had sex and somehow she was cleaning with her husband and then the story took a...
And then his mother came
weird
in?
Weird left turn,
somebody's
I don't know.
His mother came in and caught him some in the ass. Porking on the job.
Yeah. That's what you used to do, Ruth.
Yeah. But I didn't get in trouble for it.
Okay, Michelle, you're on Naughty Girls. Let's hear your story.
Hi, Dave. My name's Michelle, and I was dating my boyfriend. It was the first time he brought me home to meet his parents, and his grandparents were there. It was Thanksgiving dinner, and we had sex in his parents' new white sofa while I was on my period.
Oh! That's just gross. That's not naughty.
No. Yes.
Michelle, come on. Call me back on Tuesday. All right, let's go with Shelly next here. It's well known that all Shellys are whores and have plenty of stories for us. Shelly, let's hear your naughty girl story.
Well, I thought I was a really bad girl. We were out camping by a lake, and I decided to kick my husband in the bushes.
You kicked him in the bush?
Wow.
I took him into the bushes.
Oh, gotcha. And what did you do? And what did you do there?
Being a naughty girl.
Okay, good. Good for you.
But anyways, all of a sudden, we heard some noise. And here was a park ranger and two school buses of elementary children.
Oh, no.
Hmm. So you got caught, huh?
Talk about coming out of the bushes.
Mm-hmm.
A little embarrassing.
Very good, Shelly. All right, we got a couple more here, and then we got to call it. Faith, you naughty?
I sure am.
Tell me your naughtiest story.
I'm 31, and my 20-year-old boyfriend picked me up from the airport a couple weeks ago.
You heard that right, Shelly.
Stop the car. Turn it around.
She's 31. He's 20.
Nice. Go, girl.
Thanks. And so we couldn't get off the freeway fast enough, so I basically hopped on him while we were driving down the freeway. He lost concentration, had to pull off, so we pulled off into a parking lot and kind of finished our deed. And as we were pulling out of the parking lot, we get pulled over by the cops. And he's a Marine, so we're sweating it pretty hard. And they let us go, but it was kind of funny. They dragged us through it pretty well.
She's 31, and she's having sex while driving in a car with a 20-year-old Marine, Shelly.
Yes.
Damn. Need to leave?
It. Yeah, I do. Damn it.
Thank you, Faith.
Wow.
Thanks, guys.
Becky.
Hey.
Let's wrap up Naughty Girls with Becky. Tell me your story, Becky.
Well, I was still a virgin when I went to college, and I had an opportunity with these two guys who were both willing to have a threesome.
They were willing to.
Yeah, imagine that in college.
I guess we will.
Oh. I know. I was good up until then.
Mm.
And so we went back to their dorm room, and that was my first time.
So you lost your virginity at college having a threesome with two other guys.
Well, two guys. I'm a girl.
Yeah, I know.
Right.
I got that.
Yeah.
Wow.
I know. Don't tell my parents.
That's fairly impressive right there.
Very daring, yeah.
Really? Thanks, guys.
That's pretty good. I think that's pretty strong work right there.
Yeah.
All right, Chris Boyer, let's review them all, shall we?
Gladly. We started with Cindy, who took care of a guy on a plane from Vegas. Chrissy was on a boat, night watch, and did the crew member in the wheelhouse. Sarah had sex on the kitchen table at a boyfriend's house. Addie, on a cruise, did her boyfriend, another guy, then the boyfriend again. The boyfriend bookends. Kim had sex in an elevator at Mount Rushmore. Tanya had sex in a room full of people because, it was a drug dealer's house.
Romantic.
Yeah. Kim, with a boyfriend, had sex at Horton Hears a movie theater. Kendra at a friend's grandma's house. She sat on top of her boyfriend and had sex in front of grandma.
While talking to grandma.
God.
What was her name, Kendra?
Kendra.
Kendra.
Charlene on the honeymoon at the in-laws' lake house had sex on the porch swing while the neighbor watched and broke the swing. Karina had sex in a jacuzzi in front of everyone and they eventually started leaving.
We gotta go.
Tina CT'd the truck drivers by sliding her skirt up her thigh all the way.
Stop it.
Don't look at them.
Chainsaw, you're so gross. Angie gobbled a guy with mint chocolate chip ice cream.
Nice.
While a guy watched, a neighbor. Linda was cleaning houses. Her husband came over and did her in the bedroom at the client's house.
Finally, Michelle. A bed was involved.
Yeah.
Just not their bed.
Right. Michelle at her boyfriend's parents' house did it on the new white sofa and picked a bad 3 or 4 days to do that. Shelly was camping, hit her husband in the bushes, caught by rangers and the kids. Faith straddled her boyfriend, her 20-year-old Marine boyfriend, on the way home from the airport. And then we also talked to Becky,
who lost her virginity in a three-way. What do you like best, Chris Porter?
Becky lost her virginity in a three-way. Jay?
I like Kendra's sex in front of grandma while talking with her.
All right. Emily, what do you like?
Grandma.
All right. Shelley.
Kendra.
That's the grandma one.
Mm-hmm.
That is three votes. Ruth, what are you going to vote?
Becky, the virgin.
I'm voting Becky, the virgin, too.
So it's 3-3?
We got a tie.
10-listener poll?
It's got to be 10-listener poll. We got to do a 10-listener poll, 888-570-1015. It's between the girl who had sex with her boyfriend while talking face-to-face with grandmother.
What the heck are you moving around so much for? Well, can you sit still, you little fuss pigeon? Well.
What do you got, ants in your pants?
Gosh, you little dickens.
No, Grandma, it's bigger than that.
Or Becky. Becky lost her virginity in a three-way.
They're both strong.
Yes, they are, but only one can win.
I know.
Higher on the poll, which one do you like?
I like the grandma one.
All right. Higher on the poll, what do you like?
Three-way virgin.
Thank you. Higher on the poll, what do you like?
Yeah, it's got to be the three-way.
Thank you. Higher on the poll, what do you like?
Becky.
Thank you. That's the virgin.
Mm-hmm.
Hi,
you're on the poll. What do you like?
Hi, you're on the poll. What do you like? I like the grandma.
Thank you. Hi, you're on the poll. What do you like?
Becky three-way.
Thank you. Hi, you're on the poll. What do you like?
Becky 24.
Hi, you're on the poll. What do you like? That was Jack Bauer checking in.
Three-way.
The three-way. Thank you, sir. Hi, you're on the poll. What do you like?
Three-way slut.
Thank you. Hi, you're on the poll. What do you like?
Thank you. Becky.
All right, Becky's going to be our winner today. Was that a score of 6-4?
8-2.
Oh, my gosh, wow. 8-2. By a score of 8-2, Becky, you're the biggest whore listening to our show today.
Yay!
That. All right. You're going to go see Coldplay perform. Cricket Wireless Amphitheater. And you and a friend get to go to La Costa Resort and Spa. Have yourself a spa day and some lunch on us, okay?
Oh, my God. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you for being such a great big whore.
Anytime.
Appreciate it.
We interrupt this DSC broadcast.
For what? Didn't your mom teach you interrupting was rude?
Do carry on.
KGB. World-class summertime rock. This is KGB.
When you're ready to remodel, Murray Lampert Construction is a company you can trust. This is Greg Cantor, owner of Murray Lampert Construction. Our team won the 2008 BBB Torch Award for Marketplace Ethics. In today's economy, you need to work with a proven company that is sensitive to your pocketbook. Please check out our website. No expensive showroom or crowd of employees, just high-quality work at a great value. For a no-obligation in-home design and accurate quote, call us at 619-285-9222 or murraylampert.com.
At USAA Bank, we stand by some core beliefs. We believe it's your money, and it should be treated that way, and that you shouldn't have to pay to use it. That's why we offer free ATMs nationwide, free debit card rewards, and free checks. We can save you up to $600 a year. And because we think bank hours should conform to your schedule, we offer free USAA web bill pay, mobile banking, and deposit at home, allowing you to deposit checks by scanning them whenever you want. At USAA, we believe when it comes to your money, business as usual is no way to do business at all. Better banking begins now. Visit usaabanking.com and start saving up to $600 a year with a free checking account. usaabanking.com. Availability restrictions apply. You must qualify for USAA deposit at home. Credit approval required. USAA does not charge a fee for the first 10 ATM withdrawals and refunds up to $15 in other banks' ATM usage fees each month. USAA Federal Savings Bank. Member FDIC.
Oh, it's too cold. Too cold. Too cold. Cold. Gotta run for sweaters. Gotta run for gloves. It's too cold. Too cold. Too cold. Too cold. Gotta run for jackets. Gotta run for scarves. Oh, it's too cold. Too cold. Too cold. Cold. Gotta run for heat lamps. Gotta run for quilts.
When you drink a beer as cold and refreshing as Coors Light, everything turns cold. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. Great beer, great responsibility.
Cold. This Wednesday, July 22nd, the Party of the Summer returns. It's opening day at Del Mar. Help celebrate our historic 70th racing season. Wear your coolest hat and enter it in our legendary hat contest, presented by Harrah's Rincon Casino and Resort.
Okay. Today is your day to manifest the winner within you. Say it. I am a winner.
I am a winner.
Believe it. I can succeed.
I can succeed.
Do it. I will play Rapid Fire at Barona Resort and Casino.
I will play... Wait, what?
With Barona's new Rapid Fire, there's a $1,000 winner every 15 minutes, guaranteed.
That's... four winners an hour.
Just play with your Club Barona card every Tuesday in July, 6 p.m. to midnight. Yes, you can do it.
Yes, yes, I can do that.
You will go to Barona for Rapid Fire every Tuesday, 6 hours a day. $1,000 winner every 15 minutes, guaranteed.
Yes, I will. Yes, I can.
For complete details, you will visit Barona.com.
I am such a winner.
At Barona, we create extraordinary moments for each and every guest. What will your Barona moment be?
It's back. 4 days only. But giant used car tent sale at Qualcomm Stadium. Up to 2,000 vehicles from San Diego's best dealers must be sold. Trucks, vans, SUVs. Make us any offer. Trade-ins welcome, paid for or not. 4 days only. It's Thursday through Sunday. All vehicles are clearly marked and priced to go. Immediate financing available. But giant used car tent sale at Qualcomm Stadium. 4 days only. 2,000 vehicles. Parking and admission are free. Going on now through Sunday night.
Get moving. Get playing. Get lucky. Get wild. Get loose. Get to the point. It's the new Luxor Las Vegas, and the Pyramid's got a whole new angle on how to party. Get here now for special limited-time-only room rates, fresh thrills, surprising diversions, and all-new action throughout every part of the resort. Take off at LAX, our high-flying nightclub with first-class beats. Order dinner where sexy is always on the menu with the tantalizing lingerie models at Cat House. Experience the magic of Criss Angel Belize by Cirque du Soleil. And play the games you crave in our stylish new casino. It's a revamped take on our unique mystique. Book your getaway at 1-877-LUXOR44 or at Luxor.com. Luxor Las Vegas. Get here. Get in. Get to the point.
Here's your problem. You want music to enjoy on the go, all sorts of new, cool radio programming, and crystal clear digital sound quality without any subscription fees. Here's your answer. The world's first portable HD radio receiver by Insignia. It gives you all that, plus lots of new local radio HD2, HD3 channels without any subscription fees, all for less than $50. Only available at Best Buy. So what's your problem now? Only that you're not at Best Buy to buy your new Insignia HD radio portable receiver. HD radio. It's time to upgrade.
101.5 KGB, Dave Shelley and Chainsaw Show, the best of program. This break is all about honor. Get honor and stay honor. Let's get to Dave Shelley and Chainsaw, and we'll sync up with Fox 5 San Diego on the 101.5 KGB.
Chain, you were just mentioning John Gosselin and his new girlfriend.
Yes.
This, of course, is the guy who had been seen many times leaving bars when he and Kate were just happy and
right.
Clams, leaving bars at 2 o'clock in the morning with strange women. He claimed they were friends. And now, 3 weeks after they get separated, he's vacationing with a new girlfriend. Well, I have more.
Dish.
If you had more and you set up the tease and we were following it up,
I know.
That's just cruelty.
That's a Roy gaffe is what it is. They can't help it. It's much like your Jack Bauer syndrome.
Jack Bauer.
I have Roy gaffes. It's the rip of I don't give a f-
What?
I do have news, though, from Debbie Rowe.
Okay, good.
Oh, good.
Keep it.
She denies that she has agreed to give up custody of her two kids with Michael Jackson in exchange for $4 million. She says she doesn't want any money, despite the fact that the New York Post has called her a cash cow. Mm. And you know how the New York Post has, like, 9/11 size headlines every day?
Mm-hmm.
That's the headline on the Post, cash cow.
Cash cow.
In gigantic letters. In an open letter to the media, her attorney says, Ms. Rowe will not accept any financial compensation beyond the spousal support that she and Michael agreed to several years ago, which was $8 million for her to go away. Yeah, she denies she wants $4 million because she wants four more. She wants
right.
$8
million. Right.
You know that's what happened. She got $8 million to go away years ago.
Right.
So I don't find it that unusual that she wants $4 million now. Hey, Us Weekly just announced there is no truth to the story that Paul McCartney is going to be playing on the roof of Letterman's studio tonight. You know McCartney's on Letterman tonight?
Yeah.
And this is McCartney's first return visit to the Ed Sullivan Theater, where they launched into American homes for the first time back, I don't know, 45 years ago?
Feb 9, 64.
So they were the source of the original story who said that Paul would be playing on the roof, so it's okay for them to say, no, that's not going to happen. We were wrong. Let's see. What's that? Is it happening?
Is it?
Is it happening? What are you telling me?
It looks like it might be.
Okay, let's find out.
Okay, so guys, what you're seeing right now, Chrissy did agree.
See, look at Chrissy Russo going all manic. That's why I think she's nuts.
Right.
What did we just see?
Right there was a defense against a choke from behind. Going off her natural.
Chrissy's on Fox 5 right now, and they're doing a self-defense thing, and I've contended that she's insane.
Right.
And I further contend that Chris Boyer is watching her go insane and going, I don't want anything to do with
that. Exactly.
I'm scared. Oh, my gosh. Was that okay?
That was great. You did exactly what you needed to do.
Okay, I did for real? What did you do? You had no clue. What did I do?
And that's usually the way it happens, really. It's critical stress amnesia where your everything processes so fast, it's hard to remember. But you did good.
That was awesome, Chrissy. That was awesome.
He's scary, and I like him.
Uh-oh.
Radio, KGB, Dave Shelley and Chainsaw. Chris Boyer is here. Thanks for being here, Chris.
What an awkward lean.
Thank you for having us.
Recognizable voice, yes. This is the face that goes with the voice. So, Chris, I'm sorry I'm out of breath right now, but I just got attacked.
You know what? I like the sound.
Okay, all right. Out of breath. Okay, so coming up in the next report, and I appreciate you being here, because Chris is actually going to simulate a sexual assault on me. So
it won't be a simulation, baby.
Defend against an assault, and you're going to help us out with that. So thanks for doing that.
I love it. Glad to be here.
Okay. Ooh, I forgot all about that, Shali.
Sorry.
But that's what it's about. Rolling our thighs that you just never know. And if it was probably, you know, anyway, that's not trained, I would have probably been like, oh, my God. But that's how you, that's when you know this stuff, that's how you react in a split second. Oh, wow. I cannot believe that. Back to you guys. We're going to see you back here in just a little bit.
Okay. Don't be a victim.
He looks shy and awkward.
Totally. It should be pointed out that the guy that Chrissy attacked in the fake choke had football pads and a helmet.
Right.
So he was protected in a way that Chris Boyer won't be.
He had to have some kind of a cup on, too.
He had a cup. He had a big helmet and a cage and football pads when Chrissy attacked him.
And Boyer is going out there naked.
Actually, she was defending herself against his attack.
Right.
And that is not going to be a simulation, Chrissy, I promise you. In fact, you've already had your first sexual assault. Did you see that big mitt go around her?
She kind of shrugged off his arm. And he's like, no, I will put it right back there.
But it's just a fist. I won't touch you with my fingers. Here's my fur claw. And Boyer, I know you're listening to this as you edit the replay. Yes, I just called you fur claws. That's right, buddy. All right.
I'm sorry. I'm out of breath, Chris.
I like the sound of that.
Wait till you see what I do to you.
Yeah, creep.
But the worst thing and the most heartbreaking thing, let's revisit that, when the dummy that she beat up, not Chris, she said, I like you.
Yeah.
And that's what threw us with Boyer.
Oh,
yeah.
She meant it.
She says it to it all the boys.
She says it to everybody.
Oh, man.
Poor.
Except me.
Well.
Well, you're married, so maybe she was being respectful.
Yeah, that's it.
Maybe she's not flirting to her. She's just being friendly.
Hey, Emily, did those facelift pictures go up on the website?
Let me check really
quick. That Shelly and I were looking at earlier today.
Oh, got some good ones.
Oh man.
You know, these people just look so creepy and weird.
Yes, they do.
It's so sad.
How can
and
they
Barbara
not know
Eden.
It?
Oh. Stop it.
She went again? Because she looked okay last time I saw her.
Well, you know, I'll tell you something here in fairness to them. Yes, they've had facelifts, and yes, it's obvious they've had facelifts. Usually the most obvious thing about a facelift is you're 90.
Right.
Yeah. Okay.
Right.
My grandfather used to watch you as a kid on TV. What are you talking about?
Mm-hmm.
But they also take the worst possible picture of these people.
Right.
And
the lighting's horrible.
And they're like eating macaroni at the time. It's hard to look sexy when you're eating macaroni.
Yep.
Yeah. But they're unfortunate looking pictures.
Thank you.
Mm.
No, actually, it was Jesus over there. There's a picture where Boyer looks like cutting his lawn. He doesn't have a shirt on.
Have you seen it?
I love it.
No. Awesome. With the whale tail.
I know.
Oh, my God.
That is Chris, too.
That's Boyer.
That is Boyer.
On the side of his house.
He's that freaking furry?
That's him.
In a thong.
He looks like he's wearing a sweater with a thong.
She believes anything Boyer turns on.
No,
it's not Boyer.
Oh, thank God. It looks like him, though.
First of all, do you see the grass?
Yeah.
That does not exist in his home.
That's why it's not Boyer.
There's no grass?
There's no grass.
And
grass
Chris Boyer would not have shutters, I don't think. But even so, that looks like Chris.
It does.
Really, really does. Plus about 25 or 30.
Yeah.
It does look like Boyer.
That
especially the thong.
Yeah.
That definitely looks like Boyer.
And he's drippy drawers.
And he's got no ass. Got the gray hair, the glasses.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah, those pictures are tough to look at.
That looks more like Barney Frank.
You think so?
I think it does. For the shape.
He's a good-looking man, that Barney Frank.
That's
gorgeous man.
Yeah.
Well, Chris Boyer is not here to talk about AT&T, Emily, but move the music.
I was just trying to move it.
I assume you insist that I stand in for him.
If you'd like to.
Do it in the voice.
AT&T, which is the American Telephone and Telegraph Company, David.
That is correct. Is that needed for this commercial?
Do we know what the special is that AT&T is running right now?
Let me ask. Hang on.
I can just put him on the phone.
Hey, there you go.
Chat with him.
Yeah, do that.
Okay.
Oh, wait. Oh, is he on right now?
No, the broads are talking to each other, but he's in the background.
Can I? If you put him on hold, then I can talk to him.
Okay. Well, that's not him. That's traffic.
Oh, I beg your pardon.
I was trying to get it switched around.
I beg your pardon. Well, let's see what the girls are doing here, shall
like
we?
Yeah, but for me, I'm a complete beginner, and yeah. I'm very, like, it can be intimidated by this, right?
Absolutely. And the thing that's the most important is we have the most simple strikes that we teach to the most vulnerable parts of the body. So if you notice.
Okay, that's definitely not Boyer because there's no fur on the arm.
The eyes and right to the groin. But first, we're going to use our voice like we always do when we defend. Okay. So our eyes are on the bad guy, and I want you to ask him, say, what do you want? What do you want?
Put your hands up.
Okay, tell him, back off.
Back off.
Say, back off now.
Back off.
I said, back off.
I said, back off.
Oh, dear.
Wow. Oh, wow.
Okay.
She must be great in bed.
Okay, this blonde chick is driving me crazy. I mean, let's put her in the suit.
Okay. I'm ready for another one.
Let's do it again. What are we doing now?
What's happening? So you think that one is a really common threat to women?
And it happens because she said it's a common threat.
We hear a lot about that from the Rape Crisis Center.
Okay.
So Shawley's going to be standing, minding her own business. She could be anywhere. And Mike's going to come put her in a bear hug with her arms trapped. She's going to base, and she's going to start striking right to the groin as hard as she can. She's going to yell, 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 yell.
Okay, this blonde chick has got to tone it down. Yeah. Come on, sister. Can't self-defense be a little bit more soothing?
No.
And you know what? The guy—I don't believe the guy in the suit.
No,
I think he's faking.
He just fell down. He just fell down like that.
I think he could have crushed any of these girls anytime.
Yeah,
better acting in big time wrestling.
You use your voice. You say the right things. That person doesn't respect your boundaries. We take him out.
Okay,
simple
so
techniques, eyes and groin.
So is it time for us to, I know, you're tired. It's explosive. It's tiring.
Yeah, I'm here in the background.
It can explode.
Okay, so is it time?
I have my chukka boots on.
So Chrissy's going to demonstrate what happens when you're on the ground and somebody comes on top of you.
There we go.
Oh, they come on top of you?
She said, because Chrissy's going to be laying down on her back. She could be anywhere, the beach, at home, in bed, wherever. Her legs are down.
Here we go.
Now we're talking.
Here we go.
On top of her. And Chrissy's going to initially address a threat by taking her knees and putting her heels as close as her butt she can. She's going to cover her face. She's going to lift her hips good off boy. The ground to buck him off of her. She's going to trap buck him hard, or you know what to do, Chrissy.
Buck him
off.
Good job. Rolled over on top of him. Let's see that again in slow motion.
Let's show it again one more time.
I'm very proud of you. That was good.
Okay. Can we give him a big hand? Yeah, here. Cooperation. Do it one more
look
time.
At her jumping and clapping like a cheerleader.
And like I said before, you could be at the beach, you could be anywhere. Your legs are your legs are out, and your hands are down by your side. So as the attack comes, good. She needs to address the threat quickly. She's going to have her hands on
look at him.
Face.
Damn it.
Bring your heels closer to her butt. Buck him off.
Looks like they're playing patty cake.
By bringing her hips over.
Looks like he's done that before.
And, whoop, trapping or not. Good.
Damn it. She fits right in there.
A couple to the side.
She's wailing on him.
Make sure he doesn't get up. And
he's done with her. He doesn't want anything to do with her.
Yay! You want the crack on?
You'll call me?
His last breath or something?
What I heard, and if you could see, we practiced earlier. That was a really great time. I think that I heard on the radio somewhere that right before you were dying, you were supposed to ask her out. So I think it's only, you almost died. I could see it, yeah? So are we going to hear that?
Sure. Chrissy, let's go have a beer.
I'll get back to you.
How are we doing on time? I took out my IFB for that.
About, I think, 30 seconds. Right, Ruby? 30 seconds?
Okay, so, well, this is it. I mean, this wraps it up. So, Ann, let me just ask you one last thing to kind of finalize it.
No, they're done with Boyer.
See ya
later.
Bye-bye,
you see the
boy.
Smile on his face where he's just sort of leering at her after the routine?
Yeah.
I like that contact.
He never should have gone to do this.
Why?
Who advised him?
Because not me.
Not me.
I told him, don't go near this.
This
is going to be total public rejection.
You told him to do it.
I said, don't go anywhere near it.
You told him to do it.
We all warned him.
Total public rejection.
If you told him to do it and to ask her.
He was being sarcastic, Ruth.
Let's go have a beer. I'll get back to you. Oh, my God.
Don't you know sarcasm when you hear it?
She had a week to prepare for this, and that was the best she could come up with. I'll get back to you.
She could have said, I got that thing.
So much better.
Yes.
That's the thing I want.
I got the thing, but I didn't even say when.
Yeah.
That was a fun flirtation.
I think he probably has.
Hello.
I told you not to go there.
Sense of relief.
I told you. I told you it'd be a mistake to go on be on TV with her.
Yeah, I know.
We did a 10 listener poll on whether or not, and we did it about half an hour ago.
Okay.
We did a 10 listener poll on, does Chrissy Russo have some sort of affection for Boyer, or is this strictly a bit for TV?
Right.
And the vote was 6-5.
I'm guessing 6-5, no.
6-5, no, but it was a tiebreaker, pal.
Yeah.
You know what? I would have figured it would have been 7-3. My own personal vote would have been like 8-2, no.
Well, you look great on TV. You realize that this is where I'm lying to you, right?
Yes.
Okay. You look great on TV.
Yeah.
You look confident. You look manly. You look like you were really throwing some serious blows there at Chrissy Russo. I don't know what kind of leverage she used to get your big manly body off her, but was it at least exciting to be rubbing up on her?
Yeah, it was nice. It was a good feeling, David, and I'm going to go home and change my pants.
Because she threw you off of her with two pelvic thrusts.
Yeah, she's got that technique down pretty well.
That looks fun.
Hey, at any point when you were watching her either beat up you or beat up the guy in the suit, did you go, no thanks?
Well,
she's a little
freaky. I kind of knew what I was getting in for.
Yeah.
And I figured, hey, you know what? I got decent health insurance, and my workers' comp is going to cover this. So I could be sitting on the beach for 6 weeks, is my thought.
What I'm talking about is just strictly in terms of romantic interest for Chrissy. When you were watching her go freaky crazy on the guy in the suit, did you go, yeah, I don't think so?
Oh, yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah. Oh, total Bryn Hartman. I mean, I was waiting for a dagger to come out and stab me through the heart.
And you know what? I'm surprised. I'm a little disappointed because she had all week to work on it, and the best she could come up with is, I'll get back to you.
Yeah.
You're a brave man, though. You went there and you asked her. You asked her out live on TV, and I'm proud of you.
Well, you know, I wish I would have had some time to do some lines. I had great pickup lines. I had, that shirt looks good on you. It looked better on the floor of my bedroom. Hey, are those Jupiter pants? Because your ass is out of this world. I had all these great lines.
No, you didn't.
Well, they work on me. I'll have a beer with you, Boyer.
Easy. You know what? I'm just not cut out for television.
Thank you, Chris Boyer. Are you on your way back here?
I am, David, expeditiously on the return.
I'm proud of you.
He must have taken someone else's car.
Hey, that's pretty funny. That's funny. Make a note.
I'm pretty
Let's
funny.
Ninja coin.
Hey, I just got an email from Chrissy. Let me see what it says here. She says, Boyer for president. Yeah. Tease. Stop that
president
nonsense.
President but no beer.
Yeah.
Nice.
President but no boobies.
Yeah.
All right, buddy.
I'll see you soon.
All right. See you later.
Thanks, David.
Bye. I told him not to go.
Well, he doesn't listen.
One day he'll learn to listen to
Dude,
you. That's sage advice.
Don't do it. That's played already too many times. That's hard for us to do that, folks. You don't understand how hard it is for us to make all those voices all at once.
That's right.
Not easy stuff. It's professional work right there.
Thank you.
It's the DSC on 101.5 KGB.
If you can sign your name on a dotted line, you can be having fun in a new Mazda 3 before the ink dries. It's Mazda's summer drive-off event. Your chance to lease the all-new award-winning 2010 Mazda 3i Sport for $229 a month for 42 months with zero down payment, zero security deposit, and zero due-it lease signing. We'll even spring for the first month's payment. So hurry to Mazda's summer drive-off event, where to drive off, you just sign off.
Exclusive.
includes tax, title, and license fees. Monthly payments include $5.95 acquisition fee, MSRP $17,575, cap cost $17,670, total payments $93.89, lease and purchase option $10,018 plus applicable tax. Not all lessees will qualify for lowest payment from participating lender. Some payments higher, some lower, based on residency and other factors. Residency restrictions apply. Lessee responsible for excess wear and mileage up to $42,015 per mile. Dealer participation required. Taking retail delivery from dealer stock by 8309. Excludes one pay lease option. See dealer or call 1-800-854-4047 for more details.
And welcome back to It's Your Choice. So, Sandy, for television service, will you choose satellite, the phone company, or Cox Digital Cable?
My choice is Cox Digital Cable, Jim.
Great choice. Tell her about it, Johnny.
This summer, enjoy quality time at home with free HD programming from Cox Digital Cable. You could save up to $180 a year over AT&T and satellite. Cox also gives you access to more than 400 HD viewing choices. You can't get that anywhere else. And choose from over 1,000 shows and Hollywood hit movies with On Demand. Get Cox Digital Cable for as low as $23.99 a month.
And now you can add HBO and Showtime for just $15 per month for 6 months. Visit CoxSanDiego.com. And that's the start of another great relationship with Cox. Remember, when it's your choice, make it Cox. Your friend in the digital age.
Limited time offer. Excludes required equipment rental, taxes, and franchise fees. Rates subject to change. HD viewing choices include on-demand and pay-per-view options. Other restrictions apply.
Summertime. Time to hit the water. And let's go to Hip Marine. You know them. San Diego's favorite boat dealer. They've still got dozens of dealer repossessed boats left, but they're going fast. Now, let me remind you what dealer repossessed means. That doesn't mean it's used. That means this is a brand new boat that was at some other dealer. They, you know, had troubles or whatever, and HIP picks them up and sells them to you brand new, but at a used boat price. Deck boats, cruisers, offshore fishing boats, family ski boats, wakeboard boats, all of it. Your favorite brands, brand new, but priced like they're used. Now, for those of you who think a boat is a rich man's sport, let me tell you, you can have for $13,963 a loaded family ski boat. Better than you thought, right? Hip Marine in Kearney Mesa, right next to Target, right off the 163. For more information on the dealer repossession savings, stop in or call 858-541-2960 or go to HIP, that's H-I-P-P, hipmarine.com.
101.5 KGV is your concert connection.
This Monday, Humphrey's Concerts by the Bay proudly welcomes Tears for Fears. Roland Orzabal, Kurt Smith, One Night Only, Tears for Fears.
Tears for Fears, live at Humphrey's, presented by your San Diego County Lexus dealer. Tickets are on sale now at Humphrey's box office, all Ticketmaster locations, or by phone at 800-745-3000.
Also coming to Humphrey's to rock your world this summer, George Thorogood. With Johnny Lang, Alan Parsons, Hippie Fest, Earth, Wind, and Fire, and more.
See the complete lineup of Bayside performances at HumphreysConcerts.com. Sponsored in part by TIG, Technology Integration Group.
Get your 80s on with Tears for Fears this Monday at Humphrey's.
And now, the Singing Rooster and Friend.
Get up now. Get the Subway. Get the Subway and make a breakfast with whatever you want on it. Veggies, meat, and cheese and stuff.
You're a little pitchy, dog.
Why do you hurt me?
Build your better breakfast at Subway. Try the new under 200-calorie Western and Cheese Melt. Give it your own flavor, from spicy jalapenos to juicy ripe tomatoes. Subway, eat fresh.
Available at participating restaurants. Calorie content refers to a Western and Cheese Melt prepared according to standard recipe.
San Diego is talking about a new force in town, BMW South County, delivering the ultimate in time-saving, money-saving service. Plus, incredible discounts to move cars. Go to BMWSouthCounty.com before you buy your next BMW. Are you looking for an employee right now? With HelpWantedSanDiego.com, hundreds of local job seekers will see your ad and respond almost immediately. HelpWantedSanDiego.com is simple, easy, and fast. HelpWantedSanDiego.com. Long name, amazing results.
Hi, I'm Christina Lopez on the Saquon Entertainment Network. And this just in, Saquon Casino has the perfect summer formula. Hot cars and cold cash.
Now through August 12th, the road to Wintersville at Saquon Casino is paved with over a half a million dollars in cash prizes and hot new Corvettes. Plus Saquon members get free daily entries and earn additional entries playing slots, table games, poker, and bingo. Your free Club Saquon card is your passport to travel the road to Wintersville. Every Monday and Wednesday at 2 p.m., 7 p.m., 8 p.m., and 9 p.m., you can win up to $15,000 instantly. Plus a chance to win a new Corvette every Wednesday night at 9:30. That's guaranteed cash winners every Monday and Wednesday, and a new Corvette winner every Wednesday night. Get out to Saquon Casino. You could be next.
The road to Wintersville leads to plenty of summer fun at Saquon Casino, San Diego's staycation getaway.
You must be 18 or older to enter the casino, restaurants, and theater. Please play responsibly.
It's back. 4 days only. Enjoy. Used car tent sale at Qualcomm Stadium. Up to 2,000 vehicles from San Diego's best dealers must be sold. Cars, trucks, vans, SUVs. Make us any offer. Trade-ins welcome, paid for or not. 4 days only. It's Thursday through Sunday. All vehicles are clearly marked and priced to go. Immediate financing available. Enjoy. Used car tent sale at Qualcomm Stadium. 4 days only. 2,000 vehicles. Parking and admission are free. Going on now through Sunday night.
Backed by popular demand. Over 200 pre-owned vehicles in one giant location. A huge tent to house them. And this weekend, the giant used car tent sale on the Mile of Cars is being held at Perry Ford. Over 200 of the highest quality pre-owned vehicles in San Diego, all under the tent. All clearly marked out on the windshield. Many under 10 grand. Fresh trade-ins. Late model one owner lease return. Domestic and import. Even the hard-to-find makes and models. Toyota, Honda, Nissan, Chevy trucks, Mini Coopers, Mercedes. All under the tent. Many under 10 grand. Some under 5 grand. Plus, protect yourself with Perry Ford's exclusive 5-day money-back guarantee. If you don't love it, bring it back. Credit problems? We make financing easy. Great selection. All mix and model. And a 5-day money-back guarantee. That makes Perry Ford the right choice. Don't miss the giant used car tent sale. It's Friday through Sunday at Perry Ford. 2050 National City Boulevard on the Mile of Cars in National City. Don't miss it.
Must return within 5 days for the more than 300 miles range damage. Not valid on compromising your vehicle.
Hey, it's Boyer from Dave Shelley and Chainsaw. Evans Tire in Mission Valley is now open at 730 Camino del Rio North. All stores are celebrating the grand opening of Mission Valley with the buy three, get the fourth tire free. Join KGB at the official grand opening celebration Saturday, July 25th, 11 a.m. until 3. Enjoy free Papa John's pizza and drinks. Plus, I'll be giving away free Evans Tire oil change gift certificates every 15 minutes. You can also score free Def Leppard concert tickets and enter to win one of Evans Tire's grand prize giveaways, including four new wheels, four tires, four oil changes, and free alignment valued at $1,500 or a three-day, two-night hotel stay in your choice of 26 different cities. Check out the new Evans Tire, now open 730 Camino del Rio North. Same quality, same great prices on your favorite brands of tires. Don't miss the fun with me, Boyer from the DSC, plus a special appearance by the Pirelli Girls July 25th, 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. Details, call 866-456-EVANS-TIRE.
The Constitution protects your right to own a firearm, but it doesn't protect you from the bureaucratic madness of fees and taxes. Currently, there is some consumer protection in place, but for how long? Now is the time to buy a firearm at American Shooting Center, San Diego's premier indoor shooting range and retail store. The selection is huge, the pricing affordable, and you can always try before you buy. Visit American Shooting Center today, 5590 Ruffin Road off the 52, or call 858-279-7233.
DSC in the morning.
In a world where your bit is going along great, he'll jump out from behind the snare drum and kill it.
I killed it!
World-class rock all day.
101.5 KGB FM, San Diego.
101.5 KGB, Dave Shelley and Chainsaw Show, the best of program. Boy, you're playing back the good stuff. Coming in with Chainsaw Sports, we'll talk Padres this break and Tour de France update, Tour de France, Tour de France, Pamplonada, and we talk about the dog family reunion. Our friend upstairs, Katie Bennett, has a couple of good dogs. We like them. They're Shih Tzus. We don't hold that against them. Yet, this past weekend, she had a grip of Shih Tzus at her house for a dog family reunion. We'll get into that this break and next on the 101.5 KGB Best of DSC, right along with Chainsaw Sports.
morning with DSC. Thank you for switching us on. Let's get right to the Sports Network with Cookie Randolph.
Good morning.
Well, good morning. And thank you, Dave Rickard. Shut it down. Chris Boyer, Ruth 66. Emily McGuire. Hello again, everybody. In the sports world. The Padres head into the All-Star break on a high note, blasting the Giants 10-4 yesterday in San Francisco, sending a message that is reverberating throughout big league baseball. And that message is, we're 20 games out of first at the All-Star break.
Oh.
Kevin Kuzmanoff swung the big bat yesterday, going 4-for-5 on the day, including this.
Hit into left center field and hit pretty well. Rowan on the move. This ball is gone. And it's a three spot for the Padres here in the first inning.
Thanks for the excitement. Only the Washington Nationals are further out of first place in all six divisions of baseball. Washington is not only 22.5 games out of first place in the National League Central Division, but $11.5 trillion in the federal budget deficit. If Washington can turn it around after the All-Star break, we could balance the budget in time for the 2059 World Series. The All-Star game is tomorrow in St. Louis. Adrian Gonzalez and reliever Heath Bell will represent the Padres. Former Padres in tomorrow's All-Star game include Jason Bay, Shane Victorino, and Trevor Hoffman, who has 20 saves. Heath Bell has 23, tied for tops in the league.
Isn't that interesting?
The Padres resume regular season action of this Thursday night at Petco Park against the Rockies. They're still riding bikes in France after 9 stages. Lance Armstrong is in 3rd place by 8 seconds. He's in the hunt. They got chased by bulls in Spain last week. Sadly, there was a fatality during the running of the bulls in Pamplona, Spain. Narrow cobblestone streets, dozens of crazed and scared 1,500-pound wild animals with hooves and a bunch of drunken morons. What could possibly have been the mishap? I can't figure it out. And finally, this one last baseball note. Watching the Padres fall behind early and then eventually 8-0 on Friday night, many Padre fans tuned out early or didn't even tune in at all. But if you missed something cool at the end, for the Giants anyway.
Whiteside drops the sign. Sanchez says yes. The 2-2 pitch and a curveball struck him out looking. A no-hitter for Jonathan Sanchez. And the Giants race out onto the field to jump on the back of 26-year-old Jonathan Sanchez, who has become the first Giants pitcher in 33 years to pitch a no-hitter. And among those to congratulate Sanchez, his 45-year-old teammate, Randy Johnson, who himself has pitched 2 no-hitters in his brilliant career, and whose start Sanchez made tonight.
That's right. Sanchez was a sub for Randy Johnson and goes out and pitches a no-hitter. For baseball purists, always a thrill to see a no-hitter because it's so rare. The 7th time the Padres have been no-hit, so I guess it's not that rare. For us, anyway. A thrill Padre fans have never realized for the hometown team. No Padre pitcher has ever pitched a no-hitter dating back to its first season in 1969. Hit other sports, David.
Do you remember how mad Abramus would get at you for suggesting that even though your team lost, your team was on the losing end of a no-hitter, it's a thrill to see a no-hitter?
Yes, I recall that.
Oh, he would get livid with you.
Mm-hmm.
Even if all you're going to get, you're going to lose the game 8-0, doesn't matter. You've got to bust up that no-hitter. I don't care if it's a one-hitter. You've got to do it.
It would have been fine to bust it up, but it's also a thrill to see the guy jump up and down and have that once-in-a-career, well, for most people, moment.
Speaking of thrilling.
Yeah.
We got a text from Katie.
Mm-hmm.
Who clarifies it wasn't a birthday party. It was, in fact, a family reunion for shitsters.
Oh, I stand corrected.
That makes it better, Katie.
I stand corrected. Sorry, Katie.
So what's the birthday party for them? I wonder what zodiac sign they are.
So that means it wasn't even a birthday party.
Family
Our
reunion.
Former boss, Tad Smalls.
Yes.
Fashioned together a little wagon.
Yes.
For the Shih Tzus to travel about during the Shih Tzu family reunion.
It's a pretty big wagon. They can put their ice chest on it for their picnic in the park when the dogs go listen to music. But it looks pretty gay.
No.
Wow.
Yeah.
Depends on what outfit the little dogs are wearing.
It is 6:33:25, and this is your
101.5
KGB Sports Network. Oh!
DSC on KGB.
101.5 KGB, Dave Shelley and Chainsaw Show. You got it here on the Best of program, playing the good stuff for you on a Saturday. Stick around. We've got hot songs, Name Is Your Buzzer coming up, and we'll do Chainsaw Sports plus a great brand new television show pilot idea. All that on the to-do list for you. This break, we'll talk Dave's News, McCartney, Dave's Nicole with her Desert Island 5, plus Katie Bennett calls to defend the indefensible. This is the Best of DSC, and you are on the KGBFM San Diego.
Katie?
Hey, there's a Katie song?
You didn't know that?
No. She called Katie, left
me a mule to ride. Do you know who's singing this?
No.
It's the Blues Brothers.
Wow. Oh, awesome.
It's the opening titles song from the Blues Brothers movie. She caught the Katie. It's almost like your name is a disease. And I think Sugarland or someone sings Katie Wants a Fast One.
I think it's Clint Black and Steve Warner.
Okay, there you go. So yes, there is a Katie song, of course. But I called to get details on the Shih Tzu family reunion from this past weekend.
Yeah, I realized once you said it on air that the family reunion didn't sound much better than the birthday party.
That hit you, huh?
Yeah.
Is it true that your husband, Tad Smalls, our former program director,
wanted absolutely nothing to do with it? You're right.
Okay. That's encouraging.
Yes, it is.
That's encouraging.
Yeah, he thought I was insane.
And yet, he was whipped into participating and actually fashioned a wagon together.
Well, the wagon is for a different day.
What is
the wagon is when we take the dogs long distances because they're small. So when we go all the way down to the park, then we put the dogs in the wagon.
To listen to the concerts, right?
Yeah. To take
the dogs are big music lovers, right?
I see. Dogs can't
the
walk.
Dogs are music lovers.
Yes.
And you can tell this by the way they kind of do that white man overbite. To
the way they sing along.
Yeah.
It's a underbite, but yeah. They do that. They kind of jog their head a little bit to the music back and forth. They love it.
Now, Katie is one of our very successful sales executives here at Clear Channel. And her immediate supervisor is our sales manager, Cass.
Mm-hmm.
And you two have dogs from the same litter?
Not from the same litter, but they're from the same... I bought them from the same lady. They're semi-related. And so we had all of Cass's litter mates, you know, her puppy's litter mates there, and then a bunch of other dogs. So there were 10 dogs in total.
It's a family tree thing. They have a shield. It dates all the way back to Ireland, I think.
Coat of arms.
Yeah.
So a bunch of little rat dogs got together to see if they recognize each other this weekend?
Yes.
Did they like say, now how are we second cousins once removed? And what's the difference between a second cousin and a once removed? And did they have that discussion at the reunion?
Are there name tags? Hi, I'm Mr. Snuffles.
Foo-foo.
What is your dog?
We had a lot of fun, and there was a lot of good food and wine and different things. But I have to admit that my dogs kind of looked at me like, why did you bring all these dogs to our house?
Right.
He seemed really overwhelmed.
And so your husband was appropriately disgusted by this behavior?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Good.
He was. Right, yeah.
And what is your little Shih Tzu's name?
Amber and Bella.
You have two. Mm-hmm. I see. Mm-hmm. And what did Cass name her dog?
Bentley.
Yeah. I heard she loves that dog so much that she's basically getting rid of all her other pets.
She doesn't have any other pets. She has the cat, and they're keeping the cat.
That's what I heard. I heard that the cat is just like second citizen now.
Well, the cat's having some issues with accepting the bee. The Bentley.
The bee?
The bee is what Cass calls him.
The bee.
The bee. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The bee.
Yes. The bee is what she calls him.
Good Lord.
But Charlie doesn't take to the bee that much, and so I think there's some issues, health issues.
Like, go look at that coyote.
Gonna take the kid for a ride.
One of the things that I thought was funny about the dog party was that this gal came and she brought the bee's sister.
Uh-huh.
She said to Cass that Cass and the bee look alike because they're both so well-coiffed. like their haircuts are so good.
That's it.
Wait, Cass's funny. Hair looks like her dog's hair?
Not really, but the gal said that they were both had, you know, great hairstyles, and you can tell the bee definitely gets spoiled. She definitely is brushed every day, you know.
Chainsaw, when I hold this paper up in front of my face, parents and single people like Shelley and Boyer and Katie cannot hear me.
And when I hold this up, I can only hear you.
We hear you.
People with dogs who don't have kids are dorks.
Yeah.
Dorks.
Yeah, they are.
Oh, my God.
Why don't you just have
I would
kids?
Never say that out loud, though.
No.
That's why I said it privately to you.
Exactly.
Glad I can't hear that.
And Ruth is the one who threw you under the bus.
I know. Because I put pictures up.
Yeah.
On your Facebook?
Yeah. It's my favorite thing about Facebook. You see everybody's pictures about everything.
I know it.
I love looking at people's pictures.
I like to take pictures of my food. Put it up.
People, when people tell me why they Facebook, it just cements my reason not to.
Not right. to do
it.
Like,
that sounds awful. Well, it's like, hey, you want to go get the flu?
No.
No, well, I don't.
The biggest reason that I started it is to talk to all my nieces and nephews and great nieces that live back in Pennsylvania. Because, you know, all
the email doesn't work.
Use the phone.
But all the kids are on. But, you know, they're all busy and it's 3 hours different. So it's just fun to see them on there. Plus, I asked my brother, do you have any pictures of your son? No. And my nephew has like 500 pictures of himself.
Oh, Jesus.
Every, it's at 10 o'clock.
Every 500.
I'm serious. Mm-hmm. Of every party and every concert he's
party.
Ever been to.
It's a me party. Mm-hmm. Look at me. Here's me standing. Here's me sitting. Here's me eating.
You know, like how Emily's the queen of holding the camera out in front of herself? And my nephew is really good at that, too. Him and all these beautiful girls. And
marvelous.
Mm-hmm. Well, I miss out in their lives. So
the
I
giant
see all
Popeye
pictures.
Forearms that's closest to the camera, that whole look.
Why do you call that? Why do you call that miss out as opposed to maybe being spared?
Right.
No, I've missed out on them growing up. Because, you know, when you're the aunt in California, you know, every once in a while somebody will send you a picture in the mail. But nobody does that anymore since everyone has digital now. So you just see the pictures online. And then I got to beg for them. So I just see them on Facebook now.
I'm going to my box and I won't be doing this
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, I won't either.
It's just not going to happen.
I think it just sounds like a good way for an employer to check up on you and find the cross-dressing photos of you with the bullwhip in your rectum.
That's what you were afraid of.
Well, I haven't seen any of those yet.
we're going to talk about your job.
Katie, I guess you think we're so over budget that you can just dilly-dally all day and not come to work, so whatever. I'm already at work.
I got
to
go back to work right now.
Gotta go. Busy.
Bye, Katie. The train pulled out.
Katie. Little family reunion for a bunch of rat dogs.
Yeah. Shih Tzus.
Watch your step.
There they are.
Oh, dear.
Oh, my God. Emily just put a picture up.
These are people
girls.
That I know that I hang out with.
One, two, three, four, five, six. Is that six yappy dogs on one couch?
I don't know.
There's seven dogs.
Oh, God. Seven yappy dogs on one couch.
And a bunch of yappy women.
Oh.
She said there were 10 total at the party.
Oh, my God.
Can you imagine the misery? Oh, look, little God. Hair bows.
Oh.
You know, there's something about those dogs. You know, those dogs live to be like 20. Okay. And by the time they're like 4 weeks old, mm-hmm. they've got eye stains and eye crap around the fur in their eyes that just never, ever goes away, ever.
The white ones with that stain around the face.
Yeah.
I think you have to buy like anti-dark circle thing for them.
I think you have to buy a Labrador.
Yeah.
Well, I like labs.
Yeah, then Katie had to have her dogs. One of them had to have like eye surgery to fix its droopy eyelids.
What a terrible thing to have eye surgery on your dogs, Chris Boyer.
Oh, there's a new show coming on.
Did he have cataracts from doing some scalp?
You actually just cracked on a woman for taking her dog in for eye surgery.
You're right.
Probably got the idea from you.
It's possible.
I saw a show coming up advertised on the E! Channel about Hollywood dogs that they actually get plastic surgery, all different kinds for their dogs. And the, you know, expensive designer outfits and Hollywood dogs and all the mega millions spent on them. I won't be watching that.
No, that's
you do.
You watch every show you say you won't watch. Mm-mm. Plastic surgery and designer suits for dogs.
That was the commercial was more than enough.
Mm-hmm.
I swear I only watch HBO and Showtime, is only except for that show on Wednesday night, The Philanthropist. Mm. It's the only thing on TV watching right now. Hung was on last night and True Blood. God, I love those shows. And Entourage is back.
Mm-hmm.
Yay.
Mm-hmm. All right, very good.
If there's any recession-proof industry, it's got to be making stupid suits and plastic surgery for celebrity dogs.
That's recession-proof?
Apparently, they're still doing it.
Mm. All right. Have you made any plans for your hump of Chrissy Russo coming up this week?
I really haven't. I'm figured we'd talk about that today or tomorrow.
We can talk about it right now if you want.
Okay.
Chrissy Russo on Channel 5 and Chris Boyer are kind of playing a little flirt game. And Boyer asked her out, and she responded by saying, why don't you come on my show? And you can be a guest appearance.
Thank you.
On Wednesday, and she asked you if you would be so good when she lays down on her back, if you would straddle her.
You know, I'm going to call her today and suggest we practice to make perfect Wednesday.
Couple of run-throughs.
Now, Shelley suspects that she's going to be using you as an unsuspecting whipping boy.
A punching bag.
Yeah.
Yeah.
To demonstrate her Israeli fighting skills.
Yeah, I don't doubt that.
I think she'll flip you right off her.
You think that's it, too?
I wouldn't be surprised by it. I showed up and I'm going to show up with my ass ready to get kicked.
Mm-hmm.
Because she'll lift up with that leg wrap that pins him back down. She better be wearing underwear.
Oh, I bet she'll.
Boyer better be wearing underwear.
Yeah. And a diaper, it sounds like.
Baby.
I told you to wear the buzzy panties. So that when you sit down on her and you hit the switch. Sure, you'll get the buzz, but she'll get contact buzz. Where'd you get those buzzy panties, Emily? F Street?
I'm sure it was F Street.
Mm-hmm.
Might have some merit to that.
Not going to do anything about it, are you?
Well,
no! You're not going to do anything about it.
I'm not sure. I like the idea.
Are we counting on you to do something about it?
We'll have something fun worked out.
Or we won't.
Yeah, David, I had a transmission that went out, and I had to spend...
Got an alternator that needed to be changed. Do some car work this weekend?
I did.
You say that like it's surprising.
No, I guess it shouldn't surprise anyone.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I did. I managed to... here I am, a guy in radio, and the radio in my truck crapped out.
Oh, dear.
So, about 6-8 weeks ago... I gotta get this thing fixed.
And when you did you realize that there's nothing else to listen to after we get done?
Pretty much.
Uh-huh. See?
Yeah, it's got a CD player in it.
Very good.
Yeah. So I got that finally working. A guy in radio with no radio for 3 or 4 months. The potter eats from broken dishes.
Yes, David. An applicable cliche. What?
So I got the standard query. I got home from work on Friday.
Uh-huh.
How come I'm not on your Desert Island 5?
Oh. Well, you explained the rules, right?
I did. I said no girlfriends, no wives.
Right.
Not allowed.
Right.
So she started fashioning her own. Wants to put together her own Desert Island 5. Yeah.
Oh, good.
And, you know, she's going to do this without having to endure the misery of Boyer and Shelley not knowing anyone famous in the 21st century. For example, Gerard Butler.
Yes.
Look at Boyer.
I have no idea.
Gerard Butler.
Nope.
No clue. See, these two, they live back in the 20th century still.
Yeah.
He is the star of such movies as 300. That awful, awful, awful movie about the guy who he dies and makes his wife go out and find little clues about him all the time.
Oh, I Love You.
P.S. I love you. And what's the third one I'm trying to think of? And the women just love this guy.
He's in a brand new one coming up with Katherine Heigl. Looks really good.
Truth About Men and Women.
Yeah. She also chose David Beckham.
Oh, yeah.
I thought about him.
But soccer guy, plays the Galaxy, used to be...
Holy cow.
Would you be able to pick him out of a lineup? That's the big question.
What color is his hair?
Not. He says no. He can't find David Beckham in a lineup.
What color is his hair?
Blonde.
Well, they have some tips. He has some blonde tips.
Depends on how long it is.
Yeah.
There's some photographs of him with, like, almost shaved.
Yeah. Crew cut.
That's kind of tough.
Yeah.
But he's in a lot of magazine ads.
Yes.
So good looking.
Yeah.
Do you ever look... What magazines do you look at? Anything popular?
Road and Track, Car and Driver, Motor Trend.
Mark Martin's a pretty good looking guy.
Who?
The 50-year-old who won NASCAR last...
If it isn't about a car, you don't read it. Or a fish.
Richard Petty, David.
Or a transistor.
Don Trudeau.
Yeah.
But you never look at Entertainment Weekly or Pick Up a People or...
Why?
Because it's pop culture and our show's about pop culture. It's homework for the show.
You know what? There are plenty of other people on this show who do that type of homework. So,
yeah, but when it's required knowledge, you torpedo it.
I mean, I wanted Angie Harmon on my list.
I wanted Marissa Miller. You two torpedoed that.
I wanted Allie Larder. Sports Illustrated Swimsuit Edition. How could you not know who she is?
And honestly, if I saw
beautiful
a picture of her every day with a caption that had her name on it, after 5 days, I probably still couldn't.
Well, then you're just stupid.
Yeah, I am. I totally am stupid.
How can you be so stupid about hot chicks?
It's not like I'm going to get to bone them.
So
I don't spend my time going, gee, I sure wish that hot girl from 51st Dates was here.
They're fun to look at.
Well, that's a good point. That's
rubbing out
point.
To her.
Yeah, but that's what this bit is all about.
Well, I understand that.
This is a fantasy bit, and that's what it's all about.
I understand that, except that I'm poorly equipped.
He's a reality-based bankologist.
And I mean, what are the 500 hot chicks I'm supposed to be able to picture all of them?
Just 10,
wasn't
20,
500.
Maybe the top
30. Well, no, but I mean, who knows who you're going to pick?
Well, we picked some of the most popular people on planet Earth today.
Yeah.
And chicks like Angie Harmon, who's been on TV for 20 years.
You came up with 5 for yourself.
I did.
Came up with 6, actually. First, you cheated and tried to take your girlfriend, Chrissy Russo.
I know.
Fortunately, I was there to make sure that could be corrected. You're welcome.
Thank you, David.
Yeah. Thank you, Dave.
You're welcome. Paul McCartney's going to do an appearance on David Letterman.
Oh, really?
Wednesday, he'll be interviewed and perform in the theater where the Beatles made their famous American debut.
Nice.
The Ed Sullivan Show 45 years ago.
Oh, my God, 45?
It will be his first appearance on Letterman's CBS show. Way to go, Dave. We're done with him. We had him. You can try it out if you want.
Sloppy seconds.
I saw that show 45 years
ago. Feb 9, 1964, and he was on the week later, Feb 16.
Have you guys, by the way, have you looked at our Desert Island 5 pages?
No.
Oh.
Let's go.
Yes, please, let's. I think you'll enjoy it so much.
Did Emily pick some hot picks?
Just go. Yeah, of course we put pictures next to.
No, I said Emily pick some hot picks.
Ruth, are you going to go and look?
I'm on my way.
I'm smelling an RF.
How rude. How rude.
Well, Dave, yes, that's perfect.
Correct. 101KGB.com.
Nice. Nice.
Emily, what did you do?
Boyer, tell me again, who's on your page?
Wow.
All of the girls. Remember,
Heidi and Furky are my favorites.
Remember the show idea Dave had about getting a video snapshot of somebody just right before they poop their pants.
That's everybody.
These are the photos.
Well, you chose Fergie.
Yeah.
And so we snapped a picture of her while she was right here in San Diego.
Good.
Okay, she wet her pants, whatever.
Whatever.
Who here hasn't wet their pants at one time or another?
I did.
As a baby.
You chose Heidi Pratt.
Yeah. She's all crying.
Well, whatever. She's probably tears of joy knowing that she's been selected to Chris Boyer's Island. Who else is on there?
Carrie Underwood.
Carrie Underwood looking good.
got her mouth wide open, slogging down a drink.
Oh, Kim Kardashian.
Kim Kardashian looks like maybe she missed with some of the SPF 30.
No makeup, no hair done.
Prepping for facial surgery at that time.
And who's your fifth?
Avril Lavigne.
She looks good.
No makeup,
almost
no hair.
Almost unrecognizable, but Avril Lavigne. It's an interesting pick.
He's the only girl I could think of.
Yeah.
Sensational. Emily. Good job.
That is too good. On Heidi.
And it looks like
Heidi looks like they're just, really? Chris Boyer's Island? No!
And arguably the hottest one of them all, Carrie Underwood.
Uh-huh.
Candid shot at the Ivy at 1 a.m.
All the pictures of me ever taken when I was drunk, I always had my mouth open like that, too. Really? Eyes closed, mouth open.
Boyer leading off with a bedwetter.
Awesome.
And make sure you scroll down and see Voice in the Heads pick
That's
as well.
Perfect.
Now, I want Sarah Palin.
Who's on? Well, you can do trading, you know.
Uh-huh.
There's always trading.
Voice in the Head has Kate Gosselin, Sarah Palin, Perez Hilton with a black
Never
eye and
better.
Pink hair, O.J. Simpson, and Tom Cruise when he was arguing with Matt Lauer on the Today
You're glib,
show.
Matt. You're being
that's
glib.
That's a pretty good batch there, Voice in the Head. I gotta even give props on that one.
You gotta remember, I only like Tom Cruise when he's telling everybody that men's are dead.
Yeah. Right. Because you're against those, right?
Damn right. Yeah. They don't work their scam.
That's right.
O.J. Simpson. And what'd you pick a gay guy for?
Well, because I'm not a homophobe like you are.
Well, what's with you, Ruth?
Malcolm Boyce no the heck got to pick men and women and I didn't.
So bitter about that.
Squirt some tears, punk.
Love Emily's Island, except for Prince Harry. A little dweeb.
Little dweeb.
Look at that little face.
Who's on Ruth's Island?
She has Rihanna, Frida Pinto, Salma Hayek, Heather Graham, and Naomi Campbell, the supermodel.
Those are pretty strong.
Yeah.
Did you get the Rihanna picture where she's wearing those silver pasties?
No.
But she looks like she's about to hurt you.
Chainsaw's got all hot pictures, too. Audrina Partridge eating that burger. Danica Patrick looking over her shoulder
in a windstorm.
Halle Berry looking all sultry.
Yeah, some unusual choices on there. Halle Berry and Jennifer Aniston.
Uh-huh. Those good pictures of them.
Yeah, they're good pictures, but boy, between the two of them, they make up for over 75% of the world's annoyance. Which is the best picture on Boyer's Island? I'm going with Heidi.
Heidi, but hands down.
If it isn't Heidi, it's got to be Fergie.
Yeah.
Because when you get a chick who can wet her
pants.
That's
your Miss America and first runner-up right there.
Yeah.
But that's Heidi's the best
one. Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Happy about that.
Really? Boyer's Island? No! Spraying that stuff on her hair. No makeup.
Link Sue! That's the only revenge I have at this point.
All right, go to 101kgb.com. The keyword is Dave, and you'll be able to see all our islands there. Right now, we are saying hello to you. Welcome to the DSC.
Good morning.
Hi, who do I have the pleasure of speaking with?
You're speaking with Christopher. How you doing?
All right, Christopher, great. Thank you for asking. Tell me you know the reference for today.
Stupid.
Stupid it is, and this is what I have for you. Your choice, Greg Allman, Gladiator Challenge, Dimitri Martin, advanced screening of Funny People, Sebastian Maniscalco's DVD. I do have TV's Rhonda.
Oh, how do you hang on to that?
Or, of course, the wonder and the thrill that lurks in Emily's box.
Hey, how about we go with Emily's box?
Going with Emily's box. It's not a surprise. We find this happens a lot. In the first hour, the early risers, the dawn patrollers, they want to get in that box.
Oh, what's in the box?
So let's go to Emily right now and find out.
What's in the box?
Congratulations, you have an invite to the next dog reunion.
The Shih Tzu family reunion.
Yay!
You have to get a Shih Tzu.
Oh, God.
I could give you one of mine.
Is it related?
Please.
It weighs about the same.
About the same size.
God.
Ow. Just put a leash on it.
Yeah.
Spam it. Drag it through a barber shop. They'll never know the difference.
What? I'm just trying to help.
I want to keep it intact.
Musicians, Guitar Center's got the clout that drives down prices. We're the biggest on the planet, and we use our size to your advantage. This weekend, it's unreal deals, like a $100 price drop on Laguna Electric Guitar and Amp Packs, just $199. Record with M-Audio Interfaces, beginner priced at $65. Gibson Gig Bags, just $15. Line 6 Spider 3 Amps, below dealer cost, just $67. Take advantage of Guitar Center's pricing clout now.
Introducing the all-new Chevy Equinox.